gotta get in playoff mode and stay in playoff mode. Every single round. The NBA playoffs presented by Google Pixel continue on ABC, ESPN, TNT, and NBA TV.
Bring your nursing career to New York or Vermont to experience a true balance of work and adventure. Explore a career at the University of Vermont Health Network. Here, you'll provide meaningful support to the community and find opportunities to advance your career. $10,000 sign-on bonuses and relocation support are provided for experienced RNs. To learn more, visit uvmhealthnetworkcareers.org/nurse.
Bridgebank helps breakthrough ideas actually break through and remains dedicated to providing financial solutions to those committed to leveraging innovation to make the world a better place. Bridgebank, a division of Western Alliance Bank. Bridgebank. Be bold. Venture wisely.
Get moving in the most electrifying Honda vehicles yet, like the CR-V and Accord, with available hybrid powertrains designed for more responsive performance. Honda, the 2022 Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com Best Value brand. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid or 2023 Accord Hybrid.
Contact your local Honda dealer for a great deal today.
See dealer for financing details based on 2022 brand image awards from Kelley Blue Book. Visit KBB.com for more information.
It's your last chance to shop SpringFest savings at Lowe's. Need a new appliance? Get an additional $300 off select major kitchen appliances when you spend $1,996 or more. You can also save across the entire store, including our garden area, and get two Bonnie 9-pack vegetables for $10. Lowe's knows spring. Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 5/3. Bonnie offer in-store only and excludes Alaska and Hawaii. Actual plant size and selection varies by location. While supplies last. Exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details.
The Venture X card from Capital One gives you premium travel benefits, perfect for seeing Taylor Swift the Eras Tour. Presented by Capital One. Ooh, I do love her. Earn 5x miles on flights and 10x miles on hotels through Capital One Travel.
Enjoy your stay in Suite 13.
Whoa, 13? That's Taylor's lucky number. The Venture X card from Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com for details.
I'm Andrea, founder of a boutique handbag brand, Andy, and this is why I switched to Shopify. I tried three other platforms prior to Shopify, and I remember my breaking point was when I would try to make one little change and my entire site would go down. Shopify made it really easy for me to shift everything over and hit the ground running. I was able to migrate my products and all of my customer information over. Start your free trial with Shopify today.
Get a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/specialoffer23. Take your business to the next level today.
Thanks to the Xfinity 10G network, my little brother's friends won't leave our house. When I was their age, internet with basically no interruptions was a pipe dream.
You sound like my grandpa.
Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas.
92% of households that join Peloton early in the year are still active a year later.
If you love cycling,
Peloton actually makes a treadmill too.
Okay, if you love sprinting,
you could try out a power walk or a scenic hike in Scotland.
Let me just clear my entire schedule.
Hey, we're nothing if not flexible. With classes from 5 minutes to 30, Peloton can fit into any schedule. 92% stick with it. So can you. Try the Peloton Tread risk-free with the 30-day home trial. New members only. Not available in remote locations. See additional terms at onepeloton.com/home-trial.
Sports Center all night. College football's top stars realize their dream.
All right, Kansas City, it's time to get the show started. The 2023 NFL Draft is now officially open.
The Celtics look to close out their series against the Hawks.
Tatum's going to have to go, pulls back on Collins and rips home a three.
Step into it, big fella. Step into it. Be the star you are.
Plenty of surprises coming from Kansas City.
Houston coming back up
to number three, it looks like, to trade up to the Arizona spot.
Plus, the mystery is over in Baltimore.
When we were talking about Lamar Jackson actually inking or deciding to take this deal, it was, well, you can't give him money because of this, or you can't do this. So now it's the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson understood how much they both need each other.
This is SportsCenter All Night.
I want to send an apology to the legend Janet Jackson. We were supposed to close out in Boston. She had to postpone her show. I hope she see this. I apologize for that, but we got it done today.
Here's Jim Basquiel.
Yeah, the Celtics finish off the Hawks. Can the Leafs do the same to the Bolts? Welcome to SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app. ESPN Radio is presented by Progressive Insurance. We have plenty ahead, like Lamar getting the bag. But we begin with the next wave of quarterbacks to the NFL's round one of the draft came Thursday with the first pick belonging to Carolina. Quarterbacks again dominated the early part of this draft.
With the first pick in the 2023 NFL draft, the Carolina Panthers select Bryce Young, quarterback, Alabama.
Yes, they do. Not too short, not too light. After all, the Panthers selecting Young with the top overall pick in Thursday's draft. First time the team has selected a quarterback with the top overall choice since Cam Newton in 2011. He was 30-4 as a starter with the Crimson Tide, threw for over 8,300 yards, 80 touchdowns, and just 12 picks. Won the Heisman in 21. 5'10", 204 pounds, considered small by NFL standards, just the third quarterback since 1970, shorter than 6 feet to be selected in the first round. It was Young with our Susie Colbert.
Bryce, your parents said that from the moment you touched the football at 3 years old, they knew you were destined for this. What's it like to be standing on the stage as the number one pick in the NFL draft?
It's surreal. It's a dream come true. I'm blessed. I want to thank God for allowing me to be here, for my parents and everyone who supported me. Although it's my name being called, there's so many people that pushed me, allowed me to be here. And as amazing as the moment this is, I'm going to try to live in this moment. I can't wait to get to work and start building off of it.
When you met with the Panthers, they talked about their plan for the future. What impressed you about them?
Yeah, how intricate they were with everything. Like you said, everything was methodical. Everything was planned out. And, you know, the way that they view the quarterback position, how much I learned from my time being there, even the visits that I had, it really meant a lot. So I can't be more excited, and I'm blessed to be a Panther.
With the second pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Houston Texans select C.J. Stroud, quarterback, Ohio State.
Man, back-to-back QBs selected as the Texans go with a signal. Carlos Stroud at Ohio State, over 8,100 yards passing, 85 touchdowns, again, just 12 picks. Ohio State went 21-4 with him under center. Mike Tannenbaum on why he liked the move.
I just like his presence. I like the way he's a full-field thrower. He has good arm strength. He didn't back down at the combine. To me, he checked every box. I think it bears repeating. That test could have been a concern, and that's fair. You do more work, you get the questions answered. But again, when you think about if we're running a team and you look at Davis Mills over the last couple of years, he was not a guy that was a pro caliber starting NFL quarterback. And in the AFC, you have no shot, zero in the AFC without a guy that can be a top flight guy. This was an absolute no-brainer. Common sense wins out.
So they get the future quarterback and they back it up by trading up to three in the draft and getting the pass rusher Will Anderson, also out of Alabama at three overall, trading with the Cardinals, sending the 12th pick, 33rd pick, first rounder, and third rounder next year to get him. Anderson, 27 and a half sacks over the last two campaigns. Nick Caserio, their GM, on why he made that move.
As far as the trade is concerned, you know, it's just really comes down to doing, you know, what we feel is best for the football team. And it was an opportunity to get a player who, you know, we thought very highly of. We knew that he wasn't going to last. And we felt that adding him to our football team was something that, you know, we wanted to do. Can't say enough good things about Will, just the person that he is, the human being that he is, his leadership. And unsolicited, you know, before the draft, you know, we received just commentary about, you know, just the praise was just incredible. But the trade in and of itself was just about doing what we felt was best for the team and the organization. And I would say trades are always a product or a function of the player. And, you know, I would say just from our perspective, it's not about like what the points tell you on the chart. You know, if you have conviction about a player and you want a player and you think the trade is the right thing for you to do, then you go ahead and do it, you know, which is what we did.
With the fourth pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Indianapolis Colts select Anthony Richardson, quarterback, Florida.
There you have it. Three quarterbacks in the top four. He goes to the Colts, selecting Richardson fourth overall. The former Gator takes over under center. A team that finished with seven straight losses, the Colts, were 4-12-1 a season ago. Mel Kiper Jr. on the selection.
Yeah, he can either make your draft or he can break your heart. But I think with his running skills, he's going to be ideal in his own. He's a dual threat quarterback who's going to go into the NFL and right away be one of the top 3 to 4 running quarterbacks. Will the accurate passing evolve? Because at collegiate level at Florida, with only 13 career starts, which in itself is a big red flag, yes. 13 career starts only, the accuracy, the missing of layups, easy throws. I know he had some drops by the Florida receivers, but against Utah, he was amazing.
All right, so then 5 through 10, some surprises, if you will. Seattle goes with Devin Witherspoon, despite Tyree Wilson and Jalen Carter being on the board. They fortify that secondary yet again. Witherspoon on what they're getting.
That's just who I am. I think that's always been who I am. You know, I've always been kind of undersized, so a physical trait is a thing a lot of people think I lack, for real. So I just go out there and just go make a play. You know, I'm just not shying away from no contact. Let them know that I'm a physical kid.
Yeah, he is a physical player, no doubt. Arizona moves back up to 6, trading for Paris Johnson, the offensive tackle out of Ohio State, looking to protect Kyler Murray. Chris Canty with his insight.
Protect the investment that you have in Kyler Murray. You already bought the house with Kyler Murray. You get the homeowner's insurance with Paris Johnson Jr. pairing with DJ Humphries.
Yeah, and then Vegas goes with the pass rusher out of Texas Tech, talking about Tyree Wilson. Keep in mind, they averaged a sack, just over a sack a game, 30th in the league a season ago. He had 14 tackles for loss last year, 7 sacks with A&M, and he gets it done on the field. Meantime, a little bit of a surprise at 8. Bijan Robinson there, despite the fact that you had the dog, the Georgia Bulldog in Carter, the defensive tackle there. But Bijan Robinson is the selection of the Falcons. Ran for over 1,500 yards, 18 touchdowns for Texas last season. He could run like the wind, but also says he can catch the ball.
I think my pass catching and how I can catch the ball. You know, when I was back at Texas, I would always, you know, tell the receivers, like, I got the best hands on the team. I would always tell them. Sometimes I just joke with them, but I think I was – sometimes
yeah,
serious.
On those wheel routes and some of those seam routes, oh, it certainly yeah. looks like it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But I think that obviously, you know, being a gifted running back, you know, and doing so many things for an offense, even pass blocking, you know, I think it's really important when you got guys that can do all three and be special in that type of way.
All right, so I mentioned 8 picks in the draft. Still no word on Jalen Carter. Thus, the Philadelphia Eagles in the Super Bowl season ago trade up to 9.
With the 9th pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Philadelphia Eagles select Jalen Carter, defensive tackle, Georgia.
Yeah, they traded up with the Bears to get that, giving a 4th rounder and the 10th overall pick. Carter was once projected as the number 1 overall pick. Questions about how far he might slip because of his involvement in a crash that killed a teammate, as well as a Georgia recruiting staffer, Chris Canty, about the player.
There are some character concerns when it comes to Jalen Carter. That is a fact. But the locker room that you're bringing him into is going to make a huge difference as to what version of Jalen Carter you're going to end up getting. Now, as far as the sports character of Jalen Carter, there are no question marks with that. This guy wasn't healthy this year, and he could have shut it. He could have shut it down and decided not to play. His draft stock wouldn't have been any higher. But he decided to come back and help his teammates compete and win a national championship.
And then at 10, Chicago goes with Darnell Wright out of Tennessee, the offensive tackle. They're all SEC selection just a season ago. Ian Fitzsimmons, this a player Will Anderson had some respect for.
I asked Will Anderson right after the Sugar Bowl, a game that he didn't have to play in, but did, along with Bryce Young and all the other stars at Bama. Who's the best offensive lineman you've gone up against? And he didn't even hiccup before he said, the guy from Tennessee, and Darnell Wright.
Yep.
That tells me everything you need to know. about how good this young man can be.
More on the NFL draft opening round later in the show. 2023 NFL draft is on ESPN Radio. Second and third round coverage begins tonight, 6 Eastern on most ESPN radio stations.
Now the team officially has announced a new five-year agreement with Lamar Jackson, tying him to the Baltimore Ravens through the 2027 season. Not difficult to see this coming.
Yeah, we have a deal. Ravens and Lamar Jackson, some $260 million. He is the highest paid player in league history. It's a five-year deal. $185 is guaranteed. That ends the drama of this contract negotiation for these two sides, and the deal tops the one Jalen Hurts just signed with the Eagles. Jackson on striking a compromise, if you will, with the Ravens.
You know, for the last few months, there's been a lot of he say, she say. A lot of nail biting, a lot of head scratching going on. But for the next 5 years, it's a lot of flock going on. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go, man. Can't wait to get there. Can't wait to be there. Can't wait to light up M&T for the next 5 years, man. Let's get it.
And you can understand why he's excited. Ryan Clark on his insight on this new deal.
It's the doubts that have continue to exist about him, even leading up to this point. When we were talking about Lamar Jackson actually inking or deciding to take this deal, it was, well, you can't give him money because of this, or you can't do this contract.
He's missed this many games.
And so now it's the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson understood how much they both need each other, and they got this deal done.
More on Lamar Jackson later in the show.
Hawks, Celtics.
It's game six from Atlanta. Game tight. Boston, Atlanta, when the Celtics opened it up from downtown.
Shot clock is 7. Tatum, right-hand dribble. 4 on the shot clock. Tatum going to have to go. Pulls back on Collins and rips home a 3.
Step into it, big fella. Step into it. Be the star you are.
That's Tatum from downtown. This Tatum on the board.
Boston by 6. Tatum to Smart. Pump fake. 1 dribble. Kick to the corner. Al, 3. Rims out. Offensive rebound. Jason Tatum flies through the air with a cape flying off his back. Throws home the offensive rebound. And the Celtics lead by 8 with 2 minutes to go.
That's 98.5 The Sports. From up 3 to up 8. The dagger came moments later.
Nothing happening here. Jalen. Right-hand dribble, spins in traffic, throws out to Marcus Smart. He's got time. The 3 is in the air and good.
Ooh, the big boy is coming down the stretch like thoroughbreds. Come on, Secretariat. Come on home.
Celtics broke open a tight game in the closing minutes. Beat the Hawks 128-120. Closing out the series in 6, advancing to face the Sixers. Game 1 Monday night in Boston. Celtics ripped off an 11-0 run, including 3 straight 3-pointers. Jaylen Brown led the way with 32. Jason Tatum, 30. Trae Young in defeat had 30 points, but made only 1 field goal in the second half. It was Tatum postgame on TNT.
There was a ton of back and forth, lead changes, ties throughout this game. What was the turning point for you all?
I think in that fourth quarter, 4 minutes left, we made winning plays. And we talked about it before the game. Do whatever it takes. And essentially, don't ask the guys anything to do anything I wouldn't do. Pick up full court, block shots, dive on the floor. Starts from the top. The rest will follow. And we made winning plays. Extra kickouts. Al made big shots. Smart made big shots. JB. This is a tough one. It feels good that we won.
No question about it. Joe Mazzulla on his team closed it out.
Yeah, I like how we didn't relax. We were proactive. We were organized. We had the proper spacing and we made the proper reads. And, you know, definitely different from game 5. And I thought Smart was tremendous, especially late in the fourth quarter. You know, he got us organized and then he, you know, was kind of the trigger man because of their hits and their blitzing. And he just made the right play.
Hey, they're talking NBA playoffs. They're talking NFL draft, looking back at day 1, looking ahead at day 2. Keyshawn, J. Will and Max, ESPN Radio, ESPN 2, ESPNU. The guest list begins with Dan Graziano, ESPN NFL Insider at 7:15 Eastern. Coming up, the Leafs had a chance to close out the Lightning, but Tampa strikes in game 5, and the Yankees get a win, but also a loss. We explain on deck. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Coming.
coming up Friday as the Knicks and the Heat get ready to meet in this colossal battle. I'll tell you what I need to see from New York to win the series. Orange and blue sky, stand up, Spike Lee. Keyshawn, J. Will and Max, 6 a.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN 2, and ESPNU.
This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
She's a captain, a caretaker, a get down and dirty wild thing. She's amazing. She's a mother. This Mother's Day, don't just gift her. Get her. Only at Duluth Trading.
Welcome to the new Fabric and Design Center at New England Patio and Hearth. Formerly Mila Fabric and Design, they've kept their same exceptional team of design consultants and craftspeople. Add just the right touch with the finest indoor and outdoor upholstery fabrics, custom cushions, slip covers, window treatments, and more. You'll find an amazing selection of fabrics with hundreds of designs in stock and available by order at Mill Direct Pricing. It's the new Fabric and Design Center at New England Patio and Hearth, 976 Silas Dean Highway, Wethersfield. There's a style to living at New England Patio and Hearth.
It can be stressful when unexpected expenses come up, but Dave can help. Dave is the banking app that could help you get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. No interest, late fees, or credit check. Join the millions of people who have downloaded Dave and get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. Download the Dave app right now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve. Member FDIC.
Take the sting out of spring at Convenient MD Urgent Care. From wheezes to sneezes to rashes and tick bites, just walk in for fast and friendly care. Open every day from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Find a clinic near you at ConvenientMD.com.
You know us. You've seen our trucks and bins around town. We're USA Waste and Recycling. As leaders, we're committed to bringing the latest innovations along with the highest standard of customer care to your neighborhood. From single stream recycling to fueling our trucks with all American natural gas, our focus is on working toward a cleaner planet today and tomorrow. USA Waste and Recycling. Some see waste, we see possibilities.
The UK's best-selling pre-workout just crashed your UFC Fight Week party. Introducing All Black Everything at the Vitamin Shop. This muscle-building fat burner comes in drinks with flavors like grape soda and fruit candy, or powders in Ultimate Red Hawaiian, Ultimate Tropical Vibes, and All Batty Everything. An exclusive collab with UFC lightweight Patty the Batty Pimblatt.
What's happening, people? All Batty Everything in Batty Betty flavor. It's a belter.
So, try All Black Everything or All Batty Everything at vitaminshop.com or any The Vitamin Shop store today.
1 in 8. That's how many people have worked at a McDonald's. We'll serve millions the best Big Mac and best birthday party they've ever had. You haven't just seen kids graduate from a Happy Meal, but have gotten help graduating themselves. Because they know the skills learned here.
Bienvenidos. Welcome to English Under the Arches.
Can help you grow from here or keep growing here.
Hi,
1 in 8 start at McDonald's. And where you start stays with you.
For adults with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy, now there's Skyrizi, risankizumab riza, a prescription-only 150-milligram injection. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieve 90% clear skin at 4 months, and Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Nothing in me go hand in hand. Nothing on my skin, that's my new plan. Nothing is every day.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
With Skyrizi, you could achieve 90% clearer skin. Ask your doctor about the number one dermatologist prescribed biologic in psoriasis and visit skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app. Here's Jim Basquiat.
Yeah, we're back on SportsCenter all night with a potential closeout game in Toronto for the Leafs.
To the right corner, 2-1 Lightning in the third. A centering feed. Cut the ball.
Shoot.
Oh, yeah.
Nick Paul! Nick Paul has made it 3-1! Yeah, 970 WFLA Lightning Radio. Tampa Bay forced to game 6 in their opening round series with those Leafs. Nick Paul scored, as did Anthony Cirelli, backing Andrei Vasilevsky at 28 stops. They force a 6th game at home by way of a 4-2 win. The Leafs still lead the best of 7, 3-2. Game 6 Saturday in Tampa. Game 5, Rangers-Devils tied at 2. Home team had lost the first 4. Devils were back home, wasting no time in getting on the board.
Empty netter, the final tally in the Devils game 4. We off the faceoff, a turnover, and the Devils score. And it's Andre Palat who fires one off of Shesterkin. It rolls over his shoulder and in.
Oh, just what the Devils ordered.
How about that? 39 seconds in, Andre Palat gets the Devils on the board. Don't forget, they're coming off the 2 wins at Madison Square Garden. Then, up a pair, they hit the Rangers with a shorty.
Rangers still with it. Panarin has it taken away. Here comes Holland. Mercer on a 2-on-1 shorthanded. Holland moves in. Cross ice. They score! Woo! Dawson Mercer, shorthanded goal. It's 3-0.
Devils Hockey Network, Dawson Mercer, a goal and to give. Eric Hallett scored 2. The Devils beat the Rangers 4-0, take a 3-2 series lead. They move 1 win away from advancing to their 3rd straight win and losing. After losing the first 2 games at home, it was the first win by the home team in the series. Game 6 is Saturday night at Madison Square Garden. You're listening to SportsCenter all night on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app. From Major League Baseball, the Yankees getting the Rangers.
Trevino drives that in the air to left field and deep. Grossman twisting, turning, watching. Goodbye. Jose Trevino goes yard. His 3rd in of the night. A much-needed insurance run. And it's 4-2 Yankees.
And Garrett Cole's battery mate backing him there. Jose Trevino going out as heard on the YES Network. Cole got his 5th win after setting a career scoreless streak. DJ LeMahieu, Gleyber Torres hit back-to-back home runs. Yankees atop the Rangers 4-2 series opener. Mark Aaron Judge's first game back in Texas since breaking Roger Maris' single-season American League record with his 67-second home run last October. Judge, though, exited early because of right hip discomfort. Had this to say postgame.
Just a little grab in the hip area, you know, after that first dive the other night, you know, just kind of the whole right side has been a little locked up. And, you know, it wasn't until, you know, the second to last swing that I bat, I kind of felt something grab. And you know, they kind of thought it'd be best just to kind of shut it down and see how we feel after a couple of days and get back in there.
Yeah, Garrett Cole's scoreless streak reached 25 2/3 innings.
8th pitch of the turn from Cease. Swinging a high, towering fly ball to fairly deep right. Colas back toward the track. At the wall, it's gone. A solo homer for Brandon Lau. He gets one right back, and the Rays are up 4-1.
Yeah, that's 620 WDAE. Brandon Lau homer drove in 3. Tampa handing Chicago its 8th straight loss, 14-5. Shohei Ohtani earned another win on the mound, despite giving up 5 runs in the 4th inning. Also tripled, doubled, and singled in the Angels' 8-7 win over the A's. And who is the best team in the National League? That distinction, the Pittsburgh Pirates.
Rios sets. Here's the pitch. Fly ball deep to left field. Going back is Thompson. Clear the deck. Cannonball coming. JoJo. He gives the Pirates a 5-2 lead in the 6th. That's his 3rd.
A little cup of Connor Joe, 93-7. The Fan, Mitch Keller, struck out 10, matching his career high over 6 frames. Pirates beat the Dodgers 6-2. They're off to an 18-8 start. How about the Marlins hitting the Braves with a 5 spot in the 9th?
Marlins are down to their final strike. 2-2 pitch, hit in the air, right center field. Acuna's on the run. He's not going to get there. This ball's in the alley, rolling all the way to the wall in right center field. Garrett Cooper, a massive 2-run. 2-out double in the top of the 9th inning. The Miami Marlins have come all the way back down 4. They've got a 5-4 lead. The Braves have blown a four-run lead here in the ninth.
That's 940 WINZ. Garrett Cooper's two out, two-run double, capped a five-run ninth. They avoid the sweep 5-4 against the Braves. Coming up, more from the NFL draft as the Eagles add two more dogs to their pack while Lamar Jackson adds more loot to his bank account. That's next. This is ESPN Radio.
Greeny.
This is the best thing that has happened to the Jets since they drafted Joe Namath. Good things have happened to them since. I'm not suggesting otherwise, but nothing like this.
Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio.
A traditional 15th anniversary gift is crystal. So for Tommy John's 15th year, they're making it crystal clear that you deserve to be unbelievably comfortable every day. When you wear Tommy John, you're that much more comfortable, so you can do everything better. Because Tommy John underwear moves with you thanks to breathable, lightweight, moisture-wicking fabric with four times the stretch of competing brands. And with over 20 million pairs sold and thousands of five-star reviews, people love their Tommy John underwear. That's why Tommy John doesn't just have customers, they have fanatics who say Tommy John has the most comfortable boxer briefs ever. There's no downside. Buy one pair, and you'll never want to wear any other underwear again. Plus, there's no risk, because everything's backed by Tommy John's best pair you'll ever wear, or it's free guarantee. Get 25% off site-wide now through April 27th at TommyJohn.com/stream. 25% off site-wide right now at TommyJohn.com/stream. See site for details.
What makes New England Patio and Hearth the premier destination for quality outdoor patio furniture? Is it the area's largest selection of patio furniture in almost every conceivable style, color, and fabric? Or their huge inventory of chaise lounges, Adirondack chairs, fire tables, umbrella and cantilever, or their competitive pricing? Maybe it's their service, which now includes a new fabric and design center. Whatever it is, head on over to New England Patio and Hearth today. 974 Silas Dean Highway, Wethersfield. There's a style to living at New England Patio and Hearth.
You hearing this? It sounds like,
yeah, this is playoff basketball.
Time to tap into playoff mode. That non-stop claw your way to the top, give it all you got type of thing. From inside the paint to outside the arena,
where did this come from?
Everybody's got to get in playoff mode and stay in playoff mode.
Unbelievable.
Every single round. The NBA playoffs presented by Google Pixel continue on ABC, ESPN, TNT, and NBA TV.
And now coming in at number one,
it's Kentucky Fried Chicken's $5 Mac and Cheese Bowl.
Mac and cheese, chicken and cheese. Mac and cheese, chicken and cheese.
KFC.
Mac and cheese, chicken and cheese. Mac and cheese, chicken and cheese.
For $5.
Oh, yeah, baby. Order KFC's $5 mac and cheese bowls on the app. Back for a limited time in original or spicy. That's finger-licking good. Price participation may vary for a limited time only.
Did you know less than 3% of popular songs are produced by women? We'll never realize the full power of sound unless the people making the music are as diverse as the people listening. That's why Bose partnered with She Is The Music to address this deficit. Together, we're celebrating women and non-binary creators in the music space and paving the way for new ones. It's time to turn the dial. Learn more at Bose.com/turn the dial.
Bring your nursing career to New York or Vermont to experience a true balance of work and adventure. Explore a career at the University of Vermont Health Network. Here, you'll provide meaningful support to the community and find opportunities to advance your career. $10,000 sign-on bonuses and relocation support are provided for experienced RNs. To learn more, visit uvmhealthnetworkcareers.org/nurse.
It's your last chance to shop SpringFest savings at Lowe's. Need a new appliance? Get an additional $300 off select major kitchen appliances when you spend $1,996 or more. You can also save across the entire store, including our garden area, and get two Bonnie 9-pack vegetables for $10. Lowe's knows spring. Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 5/3. Bonnie offer in-store only and excludes Alaska and Hawaii. Actual plant size and selection varies by location. While supplies last. Exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details.
This
Texas Sports Center all night on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app.
Here's Jim Basquiat.
And ESPN Radio is presented by Progressive Insurance. Looking for a career you'll love with flexibility, great pay and benefits, and one of the country's top workplaces? Come join their growing team. Go to progressive.com/careers and apply online today.
Half hour headlines on SportsCenter all night.
Again, our top stories, NFL draft has three quarterbacks going in the top four picks. None named Will Levis. Lamar Jackson signs a five-year deal with the Ravens, making him the highest paid player in the league. The Celtics close out the Hawks, getting the Sixers in the conference semis. Aaron Judge leaves the Yankees, win over the Rangers with a hip issue. And after taking two of three from the Dodgers, the Pirates have the National League's best record.
Officially, the Ravens have announced a new five-year agreement with Lamar Jackson.
The Ravens got an assist from the Falcons and the Commanders and all these other teams that are desperate for quarterback play. Those teams actually helped Baltimore keep Lamar Jackson by not creating any market for him whatsoever.
But for the next 5 years, it's a lot of fraud going on. Let's go, baby. Let's go, man.
Yeah, Lamar Jackson, the Ravens, it's a five-year deal, $260 million. The contract talk was constantly about the guaranteed money. He didn't get it all guaranteed, but got $185 million guaranteed. Top paid player in the league at $52 million a year. Jameson Hensley, ESPN Ravens reporter, on a deal that he says had been out there since September.
The only difference from the deal that Lamar Jackson signed today than he would have gotten in September, it was $10 million more total guaranteed. It was also more per year. He was going to make $50 million under that deal. Now he's making $52 million. So essentially, it is the same deal that he turned down in September. So what changed from September till today? Well, I think it was the Jalen Hurts deal, and I think that's kind of what kind of got through to him.
Amina Kimes on what this contract means.
As Dan said in the last segment, this turns the Ravens into contenders because the Ravens were contenders halfway through last season before Lamar Jackson got hurt. And then the defense caught up to the offense, as RC and I harped on constantly. So for them to finally have some stability, have an improvement, I think, in offense, the coordinator, and then have this young defense, it's going to be a very exciting team to watch.
Again, we remind you the 2023 NFL draft is on ESPN Radio. Second and third round coverage begins tonight, 6 Eastern, on most ESPN radio stations.
All right, Kansas City, it's time to get the show started. The 2023 NFL draft is now officially open. The Carolina Panthers are on the clock.
You heard the commish. First team on the clock Thursday night, those Carolina Panthers.
With the first pick in the 2023 NFL draft, the Carolina Panthers select Bryce Young, quarterback, Alabama.
The Carolina Panthers now have the best quarterback in the NFC South. So now it's up to that team to make sure that they don't screw it up.
Here's what you had on Thursday. Bryce Young, C.J. Stroud, Anthony Richardson among the top four picks. Carolina selecting Young, the dynamic Bama quarterback with the top overall pick 7 weeks after making a blockbuster trade with Chicago to move up to get their choice of potential franchise signal callers. The Panthers choosing the 2021 Heisman Trophy winner over Ohio State's Stroud and Florida's Richardson. New coach Frank Wright said earlier in the week that the organization reached the consensus on Monday. Young on what he's most excited about on reaching the next level.
For me, what I'm most excited to try to attack is, you know, just being in a new environment. Again, it's going to be a new players, new system, new coaching staff. And, you know, in my experience from all of them, from being around the building and seeing the players and how they move, from being able to talk to the coaching staff and learn a little bit about the system, I'm super excited to take on that challenge. Again, I'm grateful to be in the situation that I am. This is something that's huge for me. In my vision, all the time talking to the Panthers, it's been amazing for me. I've honestly learned a lot, in the little, whether it's in the 15 minutes in the combine or the 30 visit, I was able to learn a lot in that time. So I'm excited to watch how I can grow and progress under the coaching staff and being around these players and, traversing that being a new environment is something that I'm looking forward to.
So then you had the Houston Texans not only at 2, but trading up to 3. First, the decision on C.J. Stroud, courtesy of GM Nick Caserio.
Really productive player. We had him in the building for a visit. He's, I would say, as competitive a player. It has an edge about him in a good way. Loves football. wants to compete, wants to be great. Good size, comes from a good program. Ryan does a great job, with the program down there at Ohio State and, or up there at Ohio State, certainly with the quarterback as well. CJ has been a productive player. He's been an accurate player. Certainly has a long way to go. I think he'll admit that. I would say there's no timetable on any player. So the goal is for the player, whoever they are, to come in here, work hard, earn their role on the team, whatever that entails. But he's a player that our coaches spent a lot of time on, spent a lot of time with, had a lot of constructive discussions. We felt that that was the best decision for us to make.
And then they get Alabama pass rusher Will Anderson Jr. at number 3. ESPN Texans reporter DJ Bieniemy joining Freddie and Fitzsimmons.
So you add a guy like that to be able to rush the passer in the D'Amico Ryan's defense, where it's all about the front four. They all believe in knockback. They all believe in about penetrating, getting a penetrating front, trying to get upfield and be destructive in the backfield. That's the goal. That's exactly what this is going to be able to bring at the end. Even though he played outside linebacker at Bama in the 3-4, that transition should be fairly easy for him going to a 4-3 and play. And because, again, his main role is going to be to rush up the pass, rush up field, try to be disruptive, get knocked back, drive offensive tackles backwards, and, basically just be disruptive and let the linebackers, especially run game, the linebackers behind him just flow into the gaps that he has now created, So getting a guy like that to be the building block on the defense, it's a win for the Texans.
And that took us to the dynamic of the next 5 picks, beginning with a slight surprise at 5.
With the 5th pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Seattle Seahawks select Devin Witherspoon, cornerback, Illinois.
Yes, Seattle grabs cornerback Devin Witherspoon at 5. Arizona traded back up to 6, taking Ohio State tackle Paris Johnson. Vegas landed edge Tyree Wilson at 7. Atlanta, a slight surprise as well, passed on the hometown Georgia Bulldog and Jalen Carter, instead opting for running back Bijan Robinson at 8, which prompted the Eagles to trade with the Bears at 9 to land Carter. The rich getting richer. Carter with our Susie Colbert.
Jalen, you're arguably the most talented player on the best team in the country, but this process felt unpredictable. How would you describe just the range of emotions that you've gone through over the last few months?
I don't know. It's a lot. It's a lot. I just want to thank God. I want to thank my mom, thank my family for being out here for me and supporting me. And, it's time to work. The Eagles got the best player in the draft. I'm for the sure.
The Eagles guys got on the phone with you today. What did you tell them?
Man, I told them they got the best player in the draft. And, day one, when I get there, it's time to work. And we're going to win the Super Bowl.
And you've got former teammates there already. What does that mean to you?
That means a lot. Jordan Davis and Kobe Dean, I'm for the come there and talk to them guys. And we're going to win.
They got a lot of Bulldogs on that defense. Let's take us through the rest of the first round. Titans grab a hulking offensive lineman, Peter Skoronski out of Northwestern, the tackle, 3-year starter, a blue chip recruit. That is a solid pick. How about the last time two running backs were selected in the top 12 of the draft, 2017? It happened on Thursday. Jahmyr Gibbs, following the pick by the Falcons, going to the Lions, the Alabama running back, landing in Detroit. Then Green Bay goes with Lucas Van Ness out of Iowa, the edge. Mike Tannenbaum with this take.
They lost to Darius Smith a year ago, really never replaced him. But candidly, I'm very surprised that they didn't take Roger Jones. David Bakhtiari is really close to the end. He's struggled with injuries. You're trying to get Jordan Love established, and there's no better way to do that than to fortify the offensive line. So I do like Van Ness. Pass rush was a need for the Packers, but I thought there's a left tackle sitting right there. Jordan Love is in the formative years of his career. Very surprised by this pick.
It's funny he mentions Jones, who goes to the Steelers, who trade up with the Patriots, land him at 14th overall, the tackle out of Georgia. The Jets then go with edge Will McDonald at Iowa State after losing out on getting Jones. Commanders Emmanuel Forbes, the playmaker out of Mississippi State, the cornerback, had 6 pick sixes in college. New England then gets Christian Gonzalez. That was a little bit of a drop to 17. The cornerback out of Oregon, considered one of the top 2 corners in the draft. He's looking forward to playing for Bill Belichick.
It meant a lot to be able to go in and learn and play for Hall of Fame head coach. So I'm just super excited to get there and get to learn it.
Two more defenders go in the top 19. Jack Campbell, the linebacker out of Iowa to Detroit. The Bucs land Kalijah Kancey, the defensive tackle out of Pittsburgh. Then a run on wide receivers begins at 20. Four straight, Seattle, Jackson Smith and Jigba out of Ohio State. Chargers, Quentin Johnson out of TCU. Ravens, Zay Flowers out of Boston College. Chris Canty loving that choice as it's another weapon, says Canty. Lamar Jackson.
I love Zay Flowers. My favorite player in this draft. He's short, not small in this instance. Everybody wants to talk about how he's 5'9", but when you throw the ball up for grabs, this guy comes down with it a lot. He's elite level explosiveness. He's an elite level route runner. You can play him inside. You can play him outside. He understands the difference in man and zone and how to separate and get open versus those schemes. And he's an elite level rack guy, yards after catch. Lamar Jackson has got to have somebody that he can throw a 5-yard route to and can turn it into a 70-yard home run. Zay Flowers has that potential. He can make life a whole lot easier for Lamar.
And that fourth straight wideout, Jordan Addison out of USC to the Minnesota Vikings at 23rd overall. He'll be teammates with Justin Jefferson.
Jordan, one of the best route runners in the National Football League, is going to be your new teammate in Justin Jefferson. What are some of the things that you've seen in his game that you incorporate in your own?
His releases. Top of the route, creating separation, and then him making crazy catches.
Two trade-ups follow. Deontay Banks to the Giants at 24. The cornerback out of Maryland. The Bills move up to get Dalton Kincaid, the tight end out of Utah. Dallas takes Macy Smith, the defensive tackle out of Michigan. Jaguars, who traded down twice, Anton Harrison, offensive tackle out of Oklahoma. Then two Clemson Tigers, Miles Murphy, defensive end to the Bengals, and Brian Breezy, defensive tackle to the Saints. The Eagles, of course, land another Georgia Bulldog. Of course, Nolan Smith, the edge, goes to Philadelphia at 30th overall. And then Felix Ndike Azuma, the defensive end out of Kansas State, to the Super Bowl champion Chiefs. Scott Van Pelt, Stanford Steve, size up. What happened in round one?
I'm interested in who you feel like is the best plug and play guy.
It seems like it's the story of the draft, Scott. The Eagles, Jalen Carter. Going there, knowing, you know, arguably the best player in the draft. You lose Hargraves, you lose Joseph. This is a guy. I mean, think about what they just did with Jalen Hurts. Yeah. You don't think he's happy? He played against Georgia. He knows those guys. Give me all the Georgia guys on defense.
They have
we'll
them all.
Be all right. We'll figure out the offense. But I think it's Jalen Carter for sure. And then they get Nolan Smith at 30. So two for one there.
Yeah, as Mel said, that was the number one player on his board. Right. The flip side to that, and you watch as much college football as anybody, a pick that you thought, I don't know, boy, this is curious to me.
Just a head scratcher. Quentin Johnston going to the Chargers. You know, everybody talked about, you know, the receivers they have already, right? Keenan Allen injuries. He's actually turned 31 today. And also Mike Williams turns 29 during the season. But I thought they might go a different way with Zay Flowers there. Addison was out there. Quentin Johnson is that straight ahead guy, but it's pretty evident Herbert wants a big target. Quentin is that. So, but it's just head scratching me. I thought they want more of a better route runner, knowing what Herbert's capability. Just a little head. I'm not saying it's not going to work out. Just
Understood. And he's certainly shown the ability to be a big play guy. Mm-hmm. He was last year for TCU. All right. Pick that was the best fit for the team that took him.
Emmanuel Forbes, I think, Commanders. It's a kid from Mississippi State. He's got all the wild plays. He's got the pick sixes. He's done everything. But what I like about it is Ron Rivera and Jack Del Rio play zone more than other NFL teams. Forbes played a lot of zone in college. Mm-hmm. I think he's going to fit right in with that. Commanders were fifth fifth worst in interceptions last year. Right. That guy can catch the ball and take it the other way. That's a difference maker. I like that fit a lot for the Commanders.
Rivera said he was really impressed about his accountability. He said the stuff he messed up, he owned it, said I can get better, and they obviously had a need. And they had their pick of any of the cornerbacks, and that's the guy they chose.
Yes.
That was interesting.
Yeah, there was plenty on the board.
There was a 0.1% chance that Will Levis would not get picked in the first round. He's still available, Mel Kiper Jr.
I don't think it's an excuse when you talk about this past year to throw it out.
Yeah.
When Latee was hurt, there were miles in front of him. Will couldn't move. Normally, he's running for 20 yards.
He played because he's a gutsy, tough kid, and he played through pain.
Oh, there's no question about
it. I don't know how you hold turnovers in Kentucky with the offensive line as bad as it was against Will Levis. We're not in the seventh round here. Yeah. We're only going into round two. And I mentioned, I had Boomer aside, so I thought I talked to him. That night I brought up Dan Fouts, Johnny Unitas, all the quarterbacks. So Boomer was down. He's a second round pick. Bengals took three players in the first round. Ricky Hundley, linebacker, Pete Koch, defensive end, and Brian Blado's offensive tackle. Ahead of Boomer, he becomes the fourth pick of the Bengals in the second round. We almost went through a tractor pull before he was picked. Okay.
Yeah, Mel is very high on Will Levis. Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max this morning talking NFL draft. Dan Graziano joins the show at 7:15 Eastern. David Newton, ESPN Panthers reporter, on at 8:15. Coming up, first team advancing to the NHL playoffs. Hails from Vegas. That and the night's top plays. That's next. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Coming up Friday, did your team get the draft right? Did they pick the right person? I'll give you my thoughts on everything that went down on Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, 6 a.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN2, ESPNU.
ESPN Radio Sports Center All Night. More next.
Roscato is the number one sweet red wine in America and my personal fave. So when they dropped four new flavors, peach, tropical, blueberry, and black cherry, I had to try. When I want ripe and juicy, I reach for peach. Tropical's my ticket to a mental staycation. And blueberry and black cherry always serve up main character energy. Find your flavor at RoscatoWine.com and join the squad on Insta at Roscato Wine. Own your sweet spot with Roscato. Imported by Palm Bay International, Boca Raton, Florida.
At USA Waste and Recycling, we're innovators, providing state-of-the-art solutions that make a positive impact on our communities today and tomorrow. We put our words into action by building the most technologically advanced recycling facility in the country, powering our buildings with efficient solar energy and fueling our trucks with all-American natural gas. USA Waste and Recycling. Some see waste, we see possibilities.
It can be stressful when unexpected expenses come up, but Dave can help. Dave is the banking app that can help you get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. No interest, late fees, or credit check. Join the millions of people who have downloaded Dave and get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. Download the Dave app right now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve. Member FDIC.
When Shopify says you can sell anywhere, they mean it. Woo, hold up. Just got a new sale, order fulfilled, and shipped. Inventory level's good. Whoa, Shopify doesn't mind if you're at sea level. Or on top of the world. You can run and grow your business anywhere. Climbing mountains is never easy, but at least Shopify gives me all the tools I need for my business to hit new beats.
Whether you're selling carabiners or crop tops, start selling with Shopify today and join the platform simplifying commerce for millions of businesses worldwide. We've built the platform so you can keep climbing and grow your business to new heights.
With Shopify, you really can sell to anyone from anywhere.
This is possibility powered by Shopify. Start selling online today. Sign up for a free trial at shopify.com/play. 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 Internet connection required. Not available on mountaintops or seafloors.
The UK's best-selling pre-workout just crashed your UFC Fight Week party. Introducing All Black Everything at the Vitamin Shop. This muscle-building fat burner comes in drinks with flavors like grape soda and fruit candy, or powders in Ultimate Red Hawaiian, Ultimate Tropical Vibes, and All Batty Everything. An exclusive collab with UFC lightweight Patty the Batty Pimblatt.
What's happening, people? All Batty Everything in Batty Betty flavor. It's a belter.
So, try All Black Everything or All Batty Everything at VitaminShop.com or any of the Vitamin Shop store today.
SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app. Here's Jim Basquiat.
Yeah, we're back on SportsCenter All Night with more second season play from the NHL. Vegas, the first team to the second round.
One by Stevenson. Left point, Petrangelo. Slides toward the middle. Drifting. Passes back to the left. Eichel. Quick stick and front score! Stone to Stevenson. Play goal, 4-0 Vegas.
As heard on Fox Sports 98.9, Chandler Stevenson scored twice. The Vegas Golden Knights, the first team to advance, ousting the Winnipeg Jets 4-1 in Game 5. Mark Stone had a goal and two gives. William Karlsson also scored for those Golden Knights. The Knights' top sounds include playoff pucks, the latest East team to advance from the association, and second to none in the NFL draft. Steve Lennox has the details.
Number four.
Jim, let's start with the Stanley Cup playoffs. Rangers won the first two games of their opening round playoff series against the Devils. Devils, well, they're now one win away from sending the Rangers home for the offseason. Game five in New Jersey, Dawson Mercer finding the back of the net in the second period. The call from the Devils Hockey Network.
Rangers still with it. Panarin has it taken away. Here comes Holland. Mercer on a two-on-one shorthanded. Holland moves in. Cross ice. They score! Dawson Mercer, shorthanded goal. It's 3-0.
Number three.
Baseball Marlins called it a comeback in Atlanta against the Braves. Here's the call in the ninth inning from 940 WINZ Radio.
Marlins are down to their final strike. 2-2 pitch, hit the air, right center field. Acuna's on the run. He's not going to get there. This ball's in the alley, rolling all the way to the wall in right center field. Garrett Cooper, a massive two-run, two-out double in the top of the ninth inning. The Miami Marlins have come all the way back down 4. They've got a 5-4 lead. The Braves have blown a 4-run lead here in the ninth.
Number two.
NBA playoffs. Game 6 in Atlanta Thursday night. Jason Tatum said enough is enough. It's time to move on to the conference semifinals. The call, 98.5, the Sports Hub in Boston.
Boston by 6, Tatum to Smart. Pump fake, one dribble, kick to the corner. Al, 3, rims out, offensive rebound. Jason Tatum flies through the air with a cape flying off his back. Throws home the offensive rebound, and the Celtics lead by 8 with 2 minutes to go.
Number 1.
And we close with the NFL draft, which got underway Thursday night in Kansas City. And Alabama's quarterback going number 1 overall.
With the first pick in the 2023 NFL draft, the Carolina Panthers select Bryce Young, quarterback, Alabama.
Yeah, indeed. Alabama, the SEC, the Power Fives. Every first round pick hailed from a Power Five. The Big Ten and SEC each had 9 players selected in the opening round. They're talking NFL draft this morning. Keyshawn, J, Will, and Max beginning at 6 a.m. ESPN Radio, ESPN2, ESPNU. Dan Graziano joins your show at 7:15 Eastern. That's followed by David Newton, ESPN Panthers reporter at 8:15. Rashee Rice, draft prospect, the wideout, is on at 8:30 Eastern, hoping to hear his name called on day 2. And KJ Wright, Super Bowl champ, joins the show at 9:30 Eastern, perhaps having a word or two about what the Seahawks did. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app. I'm Jim Basquiat. Brittany Griner got emotional while speaking to reporters for the first time since her nearly 10-month detainment in Russia on Thursday on drug-related charges. She was sentenced to 9 years but released in a prisoner swap in December. Said she won't play again overseas, explaining why.
Well, I can say for me, I'm never going overseas to play again unless I'm representing my country at the Olympics. I'll say this, you know, the whole reason a lot of us go over is the pay gap. You know, a lot of us go over there to make an income, to support our families, to support ourselves. So I don't knock any player that wants to go overseas, make a little bit extra money. I'm hoping that our league continues to grow, and with as many people in here right now covering this, I hope you continue, like I said, to cover our league, bring exposure to us. I hope a lot of these companies start to invest in our craft, because as you'll see this season, if you haven't watched before, we have a really good craft. At the same time, as much as I would love to pay my light bill for the love of the game, I can't. That's probably one of the biggest reasons people are still going overseas. And that's why I was there. Hopefully that changes.
You can certainly understand her vantage point. Ex-Louisville standout Haley Van Lith committing to the champs at LSU. More from the bigs. Dansby Swanson, his first long ball. Cubs top the Padres 5-2. Jeff McNeil, an RBI triple in the eighth. Mets outslugged the Nationals 9-8. Then the Phillies had one run, but it was enough.
The runner goes, and the pitch is ripped. Right center field, it's down for a hit. And Castellanos, a little hesitation around second, getting to third. Now they're going to wave him to the plate, and the throw is cut off, and Castellanos will score, and Clemens gets into second with a head first slide. And the Phillies take a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, that's Rogers' son, Cody, with the game's lone RBI. Philadelphia 1-0 over Seattle. They are a 500 team for the first time this season. Byron Buxton, Carlos Correa, homer back-to-back. Minnesota routes KC 7-1. Second and third round coverage of the NFL draft comes tonight, 6 Eastern, on most ESPN radio stations. Thanks for staying up all night. For producer Josiah Howard and technical director Cam Ershery, I'm Jim Baskell. Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max is next.
Coming up next, Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max on ESPN Radio.
Get moving in the most electrifying Honda vehicles yet, like the CR-V and Accord, with available hybrid powertrains designed for more responsive performance. Honda, the 2022 Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com Best Value brand. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR on a 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid or 2023 Accord Hybrid.
Contact your local Honda dealer for a great deal today.
See dealer for financing details based on 2022 brand image awards from Kelley Blue Book. Visit KBB.com for more information.
It's your last chance to shop SpringFest savings at Lowe's. Need a new appliance? Get an additional $300 off select major kitchen appliances when you spend $1,996 or more. You can also save across the entire store, including our garden area, and get two Bonnie 9-pack vegetables for $10. Lowe's knows spring. Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 5/3. Bonnie offer in-store only and excludes Alaska and Hawaii. Actual plant size and selection varies by location. While supplies last. Exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details.
Thanks to the Xfinity 10G network, my little brother's friends won't leave our house. When I was their age, internet with basically no interruptions was a pipe dream.
You sound like my grandpa.
Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas.
Bridgebank helps breakthrough ideas actually break through and remains dedicated to providing financial solutions to those committed to leveraging innovation to make the world a better place. Bridgebank, a division of Western Alliance Bank. Bridge Bank. Be bold. Venture wisely.
Ah, hammock. Check. Arnold Palmer. Check. Motorized solar shades. Yes, please. Get your home spring ready with Blinds.com. Upgrading your home with custom window treatments from Blinds.com is a small project with a huge impact. Relax and let Blinds.com handle the install. It's easy. Just click installation at checkout. Plus, Blinds.com has a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Save 45% off selected products at Blinds.com. Rules and restrictions may apply.
Wireless headphones. That'll be $200.
I'll use my Capital One Quicksilver card.
Now that's a hit. You used the Capital One Quicksilver card, which makes you the hero of every purchase. With Quicksilver, you earn unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase everywhere.
I wanted running music, but unlimited 1.5% cash back is pretty heroic.
Good instincts. Every hero needs a theme song. The Capital One Quicksilver card. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com for details.
Take the sting out of spring at Convenient MD Urgent Care. From wheezes to sneezes to rashes and tick bites, just walk in for fast and friendly care. Open every day from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Find a clinic near you at ConvenientMD.com.
See those golden arches in every cup of McDonald's iced coffee? That's a golden promise to delight. So if you think we're just going to rest on our 100% Arabica beans, wake up to a bold new blend of McCafe iced coffee and chill flavors like French vanilla and caramel. Any size for the very bold new price of $1.79. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Give a little love. It's Missy's friends and family. Get an extra 30% off great gifts for her just in time for Mother's Day when you use your coupon or Macy's card. And take 15% off beauty essentials or shop specials she'll love while supplies last. Plus, Star Rewards members earn on every purchase except gift card services and fees at Macy's. Sign up today at Macy's.com/Star Rewards. Savings off regular sale and clearance prices. Exclusions apply.
He can buy a gun on the spot.
Hi, folks. It's Jim Cook from Vermont Gun Broker. If you're looking to sell one gun or an entire gun collection, I will come to you, do the paperwork, and get you paid right on the spot. Give me a call at 802-558-9363 or visit vtgunbroker.com.
Whoa, Vermont Gun Broker. Whoa, Vermont Gun Broker.
Keyshawn, Jay Will, and Max.
With the first pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Carolina Panthers select Bryce Young, quarterback, Alabama.
Whoa, don't slip up or get cut.
Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Keyshawn, Jay, Will, and Max, ESPN Radio, Sirius XM, Channel 80. We are presented by Progressive Insurance.
Yo, Key, why Roger Goodell tower over Bryce Young like that?
Hey, it is what it is.
Someone explain this.
I didn't see that shot before. That's a different shot right there.
They're the same sides.
Someone explain this one.
Wow, I didn't see
why did one. I have to stay up until the Giants pick?
23.
We get up at
because the Giants are a good football team, and they pick it back in.
Why couldn't I just wake up this morning and find out what happened? I'm an idiot.
Doesn't work that way. You're excited about your opportunity and your team. You know, it's just like I didn't sleep Wednesday night, and then my nap yesterday was ruined because I had knots and pits in my stomach, and I just, even though I was drafted a million years ago, every year. It's something about it. You just feel that way. Excited to see. I even had a few, you know, watery eyes and
you got the eye drops ready?
No, I'm saying I had when guys was getting drafted. Oh,
which ones? Which ones got you?
It was a couple. CJ Stroud got me.
Yeah.
He got me at the two spot.
That was an emotional one.
Was it?
Go Ohio State.
I mean, he got me because when you know, see, I know the kid from here in L.A. I know him from Rancho Cucamonga. I helped him get into the Elite 11 Passing Academy camp, not the Manning camp. So I helped him get in. So when you know somebody, kind of just know him, and you see it happening, and you understand that you've gone through this journey before, Jay, so you know life-changing, all of those sort of things. And when you look at the kids, Jalen Carter got me. Because of all the stuff that was being said about him. And then all of a sudden, this kid is drafted. And you looking at all the beautiful people with him that he now, his family and everything, brothers and sisters and mommies and daddies. It is just a different feeling in a different world. So you get chills in your body for that.
Well, Key,
first off, I just want to say, so I want to fill the basketball quota for today before we get the show started with all the breaking NFL news. Trae Young, 0-7 in the fourth quarter. That's your king. That's your king.
Wrong little young this morning.
Just wanted to state that for the record. Basketball quota is full. The CJ Stroud thing.
You want to talk LSU?
Or we could talk. Haley Van Lith to LSU.
It feels like her going to LSU is a bigger story than the Celtics closing out the Hawks.
Running the back, man. Caitlin Clark, okay. Paige Becker's okay. Good luck with that. Oof. Key, when they panned over to CJ Stroud.
No, they paneled.
They paneled over? Is it panel? Who says it has to be panned? Who came up with that?
You the one said panel, not me.
You just
what
said
I want to know is what are you putting
pan
in the car panel?
I said it because you said it. I said
I never said it. When did I say it? Never said it.
Not on live air. Okay.
Never said it. But when it panned over to CJ though, when he's just sitting there in the chair, and you just see it, and some guy's voice on social is like, yeah, just let it settle in, just let it sit, yeah, let it sit in. Like that moment, Key, where you just, I don't know when that moment happened for you. Was it when you were walking up to shake the commissioner's hand or when you were sitting there, like when you just, it all came that this blank is really going, it's really happening right now. I just heard my name called.
Yeah, I didn't shed tears or nothing like that at the time because I had already anticipated that suit.
You already knew.
Yeah, I had kind of, that was already over with days and you know, days before, weeks before. I had already kind of knew, plus mentally, these things are challenging because if you play with your mind a certain way, it will destroy you during the draft. Instead of what I did is I said, no matter what, it's life changing.
Yeah.
Hell, if I went the third round, I'm good. Yeah. I would, you know what I'm saying.
If you went the third round, you wouldn't be in the green room though. Like you would not. Will Levis, Will Levis last night, it's like, that was hard for me to, it's always hard for me to watch.
Know what made it worse? Know what made it worse with Will Levis? His mom hugging him and stuff. If I'm Will Levis, I'm there going, Ma, don't, no, you're making it worse.
Every pick though was like Will Levis. Now back to Will Levis.
I want to get back to CJ Stroud.
It's a guide every single year, though.
I want to get back to CJ Stroud for a second, Key, and why it's like an emotional thing. Whether or not you know Stroud, it's so funny how this is like created by us in the media, right? And then we pay it off. So, Key, you always say, like, did his stock really fall, though? Or it's just what we know, right? So the media spins. It's all CJ Stroud's there at 2. He's always going to go 2, it looks like, right? But the story is, oh, my God, he's falling. He's falling. So because of all of that, it seems like he's been through this big ordeal. And when he got drafted 2nd overall, it felt emotional because he's redeemed, right? He comes through and he goes 2nd overall. Aha, I showed you. But there was never anything there, right? Apparently. Just us spinning stories about it based on these little fragments of information we get.
And what happens of the fragments of little information that's out in the world, he hears that. His family hears that. Right. His agent hears that. And it becomes stressful for him because he's sitting there saying, that's a bunch of you know what. I didn't do that. Or that's a lie. Or why are they treating me this way? And then all of a sudden, somebody else jumps in front of him. And then another team, well, they really don't like him. And so he's hearing this. He's only human. And he goes from a $40 million guy to a $10 million. So you playing, like I said, emotions in your mind, and it messes with you up until the point that you're drafted.
We pump all that up.
Like you said, though, Max, now all of a sudden the guy's drafted. It's like, I told you. You know, and so it touches people like me and Jay that's watching. Because we sit there hoping and praying that the things that's out there is not true.
Yeah, and I've always been a CJ Stroud fan. I keep bringing his name up because I thought he was extremely talented. I'm glad to see him go to the Texans. I mean, Key, last night, the Texans made the move to me. Like, understanding, like, how loaded the AFC is, that division with Jacksonville making the playoffs, like Nick Caserio and D'Amico Ryans, like, making that jump, not only to have the 2nd pick, but moving up to get the 3rd pick, to get Will Anderson. It's like, okay, we're making a splash. Here's our quarterback, and here's our edge rusher. And this is how we're making a splash to show you this is how we're building our franchise.
You know what it felt like to me? What the Texans did, though, by trading up, and they bought a certain kind of, like, almost it felt to me like brand insurance. They got the nice, safe picks that check every box, right? Whereas I was thinking the Texans, with those 2 picks, you figure out a way to snag Jalen Carter and Hendon Hooker, who I think maybe are better than the 2 guys they took. But they come with more issues. They're not as kind of safe a pick, right? Like Hendon Hooker is a little older, and he had the injury. Oh, so what? But still, it's coming off an ACL, right? And then Jalen Carter,
Are those really issues? Like,
yeah, exactly. So like, I don't know, when you look at it more closely, I don't see the issues, but I don't think they were out there.
I don't know because I don't have his scouting report from all the teams or whatnot, and I didn't go do the interviews or investigations on his entire stay at Georgia. I don't know if it was just the incident when they lost the teammate and speed racing down the highway. I don't know if that was just the issue, if there was other things that was there from previous years or something like that. I have no idea.
Showing up a little overweight, they mentioned during the coverage.
His little bit overweight. His pro day wasn't the greatest pro day in the world.
Just when I hear that, you go through something like that? Are we just expecting somebody just to bounce back? I don't know if there were
teams that took him off the board now.
Yeah, I know. I don't know. There are other issues. That's a great point that
you're making, though, Jay.
But you go through something as traumatic as that, and for people just to think that you're supposed to bounce back just because you've.
Yeah, you get a little depressed. You get upset. You missed the gym a little bit.
Somebody else, manager, pass. Like, it takes a minute to get acclimated to find your equilibrium, man.
Yeah, but at the end, that's why at the end of the day, it's important if you're an organization to do your due diligence at the level and understand who this individual is so you can pull that trigger. I mean, there's not one guy.
The Eagles did, so.
That oh my God. Does
the Eagles because, did that, bro. See, I felt like Micah Parsons last night. I walked out of my room.
The Eagles also had several of his other teammates. As you could tell, they dove into the University of Georgia, and they've been there for a couple years, doing their due diligence and understanding who the kid is, and not only him, his teammates. So they can go to the teammates and say, "What's the deal with him?" They're able to say, no, man, he's a good dude. He just had this. He did that. He's a good dude.
The Eagles were just in the Super Bowl. They came very close to winning, and Jalen Hurts balled out, right?
Yeah.
Last year, they get their guy. They get their big middle of the Georgia defense tackle. Then N'Kobe Dean is sitting there in the third round, and he's like the leader and the heart and soul of the defense linebacker, and they grab him. And then this year, Jalen Carter, everyone saw that coming if he was still there. Sure enough, he was still there for the Eagles, and the Eagles don't overthink it. They just take the best guy. What I didn't know until this morning, because I passed out after the Giants pick at 25, I see our text chain, and people are like, oh, the Eagles. And I'm like, yeah, Jalen Carter. It didn't even occur to me. So I look at the end of the draft. They got Nolan Smith. I thought the Giants might take Nolan Smith. He was the best guy on the board, I think, for a while he was on there. They just took the Georgia front seven is considered one of the best in the history of college football. They got four dudes off that front seven.
And Nolan Smith can go. Yeah, he pick him up and put him down. He 4-3 guy at the linebacker.
Damn. That's ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
And then, Key, I was shocked to see two running backs going in the top 12 of the draft.
Yeah, two.
Yeah, I didn't
expect Gibbs to go that high to 12. I mean,
but Detroit decided to do what they needed to do.
What they going
to
do with Swift?
As I told you, Max, before, don't take a running back. If you feel that guy – can play.
Especially pass catchers.
You got Gibbs and you got Montgomery. So, I mean, what are you going to do with Swift?
Yes, you can find running backs in the later part of the rounds. There's no Pacheco, seventh round pick, Kansas City.
You mentioned Kamara. You know, he was in a lot of running backs going second round.
Find running backs. Yeah. But if you feel that guy at the top of the draft is capable and helping you change everything in your organization, you do it.
Especially if you can catch passes.
Making fun of me for edge rusher?
Like a receiver. So the Colts took a quarterback. Indeed, took a quarterback, but not the guy. Not what you think. Expected.
Jay's neighborhood.
We're back. Jay Will and Max, ESPN Radio.
The 2023 NFL Draft.
So you ready for the draft? Let's get started.
Live from downtown Kansas City, Missouri.
The NFL Draft is officially open.
The NFL Draft. Coverage of rounds 2 and 3 begins today at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN. More Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max next.
You know us. You've seen our trucks and bins around town. We're USA Waste and Recycling. As leaders, we're committed to bringing the latest innovations, along with the highest standard of customer care, to your neighborhood. From single-stream recycling to fueling our trucks with all-American natural gas, our focus is on working toward a cleaner planet today and tomorrow. USA Waste and Recycling. Some see waste, we see possibilities.
A traditional 15th anniversary gift is crystal. So for Tommy John's 15th year, they're making it crystal clear that you deserve to be unbelievably comfortable every day. When you wear Tommy John, you're that much more comfortable, so you can do everything better. Because Tommy John underwear moves with you thanks to breathable, lightweight, moisture-wicking fabric with four times the stretch of competing brands. And with over 20 million pairs sold and thousands of five-star reviews, people love their Tommy John underwear. That's why Tommy John doesn't just have customers, they have fanatics who say Tommy John has the most comfortable boxer briefs ever. There's no downside. Buy one pair and you'll never want to wear any other underwear again. Plus, there's no risk because everything's backed by Tommy John's best pair you'll ever wear or its free guarantee. Get 25% off site-wide now through April 27th at TommyJohn.com/stream. 25% off site-wide right now at TommyJohn.com/stream. See site for details.
For adults with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy, now there's Skyrizi, Risankizumab Riza, a prescription-only 150-milligram injection. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieve 90% clear skin at 4 months, and Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Nothing in me go hand in hand. Nothing on my skin, that's my new plan. Nothing is every day.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
With Skyrizi, you could achieve 90% clearer skin. Ask your doctor about the number one dermatologist prescribed biologic in psoriasis and visit skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
What did you wake up to today? Was it a medieval castle, an ancient cathedral, or a charming cobblestone village? With a bed that faces the passing scenery, Avalon gives cruisers a front row seat to the views of the world with immediate access to a new port every day. Open your eyes to a different kind of cruising, one with smaller ships, bigger experiences, fewer people, and more of everything. Limited time special offers await at AvalonWaterways.com.
With the fourth pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Indianapolis Colts select Anthony Richardson, quarterback, Florida.
When you have him on the football field, you have another dynamic running back in a quarterback's frame.
Yeah, he can either make the draft or he can break your heart.
But I think with his running skills, he's going to be ideal on his own. He's a full-threat quarterback who's going to go into the NFL and right away be one of the top 3 to 4 running quarterbacks.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, ESPN Radio. We're presented by Progressive Insurance. So, I'll tell you what, the Colts took the quarterback. And they went with a guy who's raw, but with high upside, big, strong arm. But it wasn't the guy that many thought it would be. Todd McShay, ESPN NFL draft analyst on SportsCenter with Scott Van Pelt. On why Will Levis has still not been drafted out of the first round and Anthony Richardson went to Indianapolis. What's up, Todd?
You look at the 23 interceptions the last 2 years, that's only two guys that were worse than him, and they both had at least 300 pass attempts in Aiden O'Connell and Sam Hartman. So the percentage of turnovers was a big problem. I think inside the pocket, the biggest thing studying tape was inside the pocket when he was bottled up a little bit and pressure started to come. I don't think he trusted his eyes, and he didn't quite see the whole field. That was a big issue. He came off as kind of not having ideal personality and maybe some arrogance and some cockiness in his meetings. That's a team-by-team basis. But ultimately, the turnovers and the style of play, too, is an issue because he plays a quarterback position like a linebacker, and we saw the toll it took on his body this past year. A lot of teams I talked to are worried that he's going to be a Carson Wentz case when it's all said and done if he doesn't learn how to protect his body better.
Key, ain't it crazy from two people that have been in the draft? Like, before the draft occurs, you start hearing talk about top 4 quarterback selection, top 15 draft pick. Like, could he be as high as, you know, 7 or 8 or 5 or 6? And all of a sudden, just like when that moment comes in the draft and just it pivots so quickly. And then all of a sudden they start talking about all the things you can't do or the challenges that you have or, you know, oh, he's going
to
be.
That's what happened to me, Jay. That's why I went undrafted.
Just so quick, though, Key. So quick, it just pivots. And you're like, whoa, hold on a second. A day before, I was rising up the draft charts. Now I'm dropping down.
Because the thing that's disqualifying for the high for the team with the high pick is disqualifying for the next team, too, et cetera, right?
Every team in the draft do their own research on the individual. But when you really pay attention to him, I never felt like he was the top dude all along anyway. I felt like a certain region, a certain team, he could potentially fit because of the style of the history sort of thing. When you look at the Indianapolis Colts based on the history of their quarterbacks and what they liked, what Jim Irsay liked, what he always reached for and put inside that building, I felt like, okay, this is the only guy that fits that model. There's nobody else that fits that model. Bryce Young doesn't fit it. C.J. Stroud doesn't fit it. Hendon Hooker doesn't fit it. Anthony Richardson doesn't fit it. But then when Steichen became the head coach there, now you start to think differently based on where he comes from in the style of offense that he had success in, which is Philadelphia. When you look at the quarterback, who's the quarterback? It's Jalen Hurts. Who most resemble, I think I said that right, yes. Jalen Hurts is Anthony Richardson. So you start to look at it and you start putting it together. But then when you hear again a couple days ago that they like him, Indianapolis Colts and Will Levis and the Manning family signed off on it, now you start saying, okay, they got a little bit of influence. What's going to happen? But clearly, Steichen won this one and influenced the owner and Jim Irsay to go in a different direction.
Yo, Key, this is where the internet messes people up. So, you know, I'm always Twitter fingers always on everything. Did you guys know that someone posted on Reddit, okay, earlier this week that Will Levis was telling friends and family that Carolina was, in fact, going to take him on Thursday?
Yeah.
Right? So
the odds went from like 40 to 1.
It went from 41 to 4 to 1.
4 to 1.
But you know, 4 to 1, Key. But just based off the speculation of some fan on Reddit.
Doesn't that sound and smell like a plant? Like someone in that camp? To me, it feels like if you want to wait, because what that does can, if you're considering taking Will Levis, let's say in the second round, you think he's going to fall to you or something, and then it gets out there and there's some credibility to him going way up high, now it creates some urgency for the other buyers, right? And maybe it actually, whether or not he goes there, it forces his or pressures his draft stock to rise. That's why it feels that way to me, Key.
No,
that
but feels check this like out, a though, PR Max, stunt. No, if in fact it came out of this young man's mouth to whoever gave it to Reddit, mm-hmm. I wouldn't. Okay, and the reason I say it that way is because NFL personnel people will tell kids, if you're there, we're going to take you. All the time, but not the decision maker, right?
Right.
They and when it's not the decision maker, these young men, they don't know. They just know the dude got a logo on. Hey, this is the Carolina Panthers or this is the Atlanta Falcons. And he was a scout that I talked to at the combine. And he told me, hey, if you're sitting at 9, we're certainly gonna get you. And this happens every single year. And when the guy get the 9th pick comes, and then they take Jay Will, you sit there and go, well, I thought they said. Yeah. And they told me they're going to take me. But it's not the owner who told you. It's not the president, the general manager, or the head coach who told you. It's like the aerial scout who really likes you, who's fighting for you, who wants you.
Who thinks he's winning the argument internally,
but he's
right?
not yeah. winning the argument. They like, man, go sit down somewhere.
Yeah.
And he's talking to the kid the whole time. This happens every single year, multiple times in every single round.
I mean, if you're Will Levis, you'll be okay. I mean, look, the greatest quarterback of all time went with the 199th pick, okay? So, like, there's perspective there. Meanwhile, the guy on Reddit, Key, has deleted his Reddit page. Like, it's just gone. But like, that's the difference in how that stuff can muck up attention around the draft.
It's interesting that Will Levis's personality, and I do not know Will Levis. I've never met him.
He puts mayonnaise in coffee.
His personality, disgusting, but his personality is such that it's mentioned on the actual broadcast that it could be a reason he's fallen.
It could be.
I mean, I was taken by that. Like, wow.
Two weeks ago, we were talking, and you probably don't even remember it, when he was talking about how his arm is the strongest arm, and he's got the biggest arm. when you get in those rooms sometimes and you speak to these people, because what I do sometimes in the offseason, I've done it, whether it was with Romeo Doubs, or I try and give them little nuggets on how to interview in these situations when they're talking to them. Don't be cookie cutter and don't be a cornball. Be yourself. But it's a certain way and it's certain things that personnel people and owners, like I always tell, you know, they got a guy that sits in the corner, Max and Jay. Some of these teams, they got a guy who just sits in the corner. He got little glasses on. He got a little gray, a little dandruff on the side. And he just sits there with his arms and his legs crossed. He don't say a word. He just eyeballs you. You know, that's the psychologist. He ain't saying nothing. He ain't saying nothing. It's a psych. He's just checking you out while the coaches are, and he just wants
to. He's labbing you.
And when you leave, he tells me, hey, that guy here, it's not the type of guy that I think.
I didn't like the way he picked his finger.
Jay, I'm not lying.
Oh, I know you are. I've heard stories about this.
He sits there with his little glasses. You don't even know who he is. You think he's just a little peon, but he's getting ready to help them make a decision on your future. And some of that information they draft on. The Giants did it for years. The Giants did it for years on the psychological evaluation test. Yep. That was a book this big.
This guy has nervous tendencies. He keeps bouncing his knee while he's waiting to talk.
Yeah, and there was a number of us that was famously Deion Sanders, myself, Carl Pickens, there's a bunch of us that said, you know what, man, we're not taking a test because nothing's wrong with us. They said, we're going to take you off the board. We're taking you off our board. He said, go right ahead.
Deion Sanders.
I'm not going to be there. Okay, I'm not going to be there anyway. Take me off your board. So these sort of things go on behind these closed doors.
Will Levis said that? If you don't do this, we'll take you. Take me off the board. Like, all right. Okay. I just felt bad from when I saw this. I saw it this morning on social media, his mom hugging him.
Yeah, and, twisting and turning in the couch.
Oh, God, that's rough. And Hendon Hooker is still sitting around for someone to pluck in the second round. I think Hendon Hooker's the best quarterback in the draft.
I do too. But ACL injury,
They want to. It's gonna. He comes at a discount now.
Part of his giddy up is his legs.
Mm. Lamar Jackson. Speaking of legs and giddy up, finally, I told you, Key, they were going to work this out, and he'd be just fine.
Yeah.
What does this mean for the rest of the AFC? Uh-huh. Lamar Jackson. I mean, this AFC right now with the quarterbacks, Lamar Jackson's got his deal. First, Jay has this from Sony Pictures.
The new movie, Big George Foreman, is based on the unbelievable true story of one of the greatest comebacks of all time. The film is a never-before-seen look into George Foreman's life inside and outside of the ring. From winning the Olympic gold medal and the heavyweight championship to retiring to then returning to the ring 10 years later, only to win the heavyweight championship again for a second time at the age of 45 years old. Early reactions are saying Big George Foreman is a 5-star film. You will enjoy every minute of this inspiring story. Big George Foreman, now playing exclusively in theaters. Get your tickets today. Rated PG-13.
Now the team officially has announced a new 5-year agreement with Lamar Jackson, tying him to the Baltimore Ravens through the 2027 season. Not difficult to see this coming.
This is Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max.
It can be stressful when unexpected expenses come up, but Dave can help. Dave is the banking app that could help you get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. No interest, late fees, or credit check. Join the millions of people who have downloaded Dave and get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. Download the Dave app right now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve. Member FDIC.
She's a captain, a caretaker, a get down and dirty wild thing. She's amazing. She's a mother. This Mother's Day, don't just gift her, get her, only at Duluth Trading.
When we made our McDonald's spicy chicken McNuggets, you were praise hands emoji. Then we ran out and you were streaming tears emoji. Now they're back, so you can be grinning face with sweat emoji. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Enjoy spicy chicken McNuggets or a spicy McCrispy sandwich and a refreshing Dr. Pepper to experience a full range of flavors and emotions no digital facsimile can adequately express. at participating McDonald's for a limited time.
The UK's best-selling pre-workout just crashed your UFC Fight Week party. Introducing All Black Everything at the Vitamin Shop. This muscle-building fat burner comes in drinks with flavors like grape soda and fruit candy, or powders in Ultimate Red Hawaiian, Ultimate Tropical Vibes, and All Batty Everything. An exclusive collab with UFC lightweight Patty the Batty Pimblatt.
What's happening, people? All Batty Everything in Batty Berry flavor. It's a belter.
So, try All Black Everything or All Batty Everything at vitaminshop.com or any of the Vitamin Shop store today.
It's spring break at Bob's Discount Furniture, as in take a break from Zoom conference fatigue and take those meetings outdoors on my gorgeous and newly expanded Bob's Backyard Furniture. Take a break from haggling and high-pressure sales with my everyday low prices on quality mattresses with Bob-a-pedic sleep benefits. Take a break from boring with my style-forward and feature-packed brand-new dining, living, bedroom collections, decor, and more. Take a break from furniture shenanigans this spring break at Bob's.
The 2023 NFL Draft.
Rocket arm, quick release, sees the field.
Live from Kansas City's historic Union Station. Seven rounds, 259 picks.
Welcome, everybody.
32 teams.
So you ready for the draft? Let's get started.
The NFL Draft. Coverage of rounds 2 and 3 begin today at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN.
The Carolina Panthers are on the clock.
You can also listen on the ESPN app and on SiriusXM Channel 80. Greeny.
This is the best thing that has happened to the Jets since they drafted Joe Namath. Good things have happened to them since. I'm not suggesting otherwise, but nothing like this.
Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio.
My little brother's friends have been camped out at our place for 2 days straight.
Three.
It's because of the Xfinity 10G network. Internet that can handle a house full of screens at once with, like, basically no interruptions. And it's only getting faster. When I was their age, internet like this was a pipe dream.
You sound like my grandpa.
Please go home.
Introducing the next generation 10G network, only from Xfinity. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas.
It's your last chance to shop SpringFest savings at Lowe's. Need a new appliance? Get an additional $300 off select major kitchen appliances when you spend $1,996 or more. You can also save across the entire store, including our garden area, and get two Bonnie 9-pack vegetables for $10. Lowe's knows spring. Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 5/3. Bonnie offer in-store only and excludes Alaska and Hawaii. Actual plant size and selection varies by location. While supplies last. Exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details.
Bring your nursing career to New York or Vermont to experience a true balance of work and adventure. Explore a career at the University of Vermont Health Network. Here, you'll provide meaningful support to the community and find opportunities to advance your career. $10,000 sign-on bonuses and relocation support are provided for experienced RNs. To learn more, visit uvmhealthnetworkcareers.org/nurse.
He can buy a gun on the spot.
Hi folks, it's Jim Cook from Vermont Gun Broker. If you're looking to sell one gun or an entire gun collection, I will come to you, do the paperwork, and get you paid right on the spot. Give me a call at 802-558-9363 or visit vtgunbroker.com.
Whoa, Vermont Gun Broker. Whoa, Vermont Gun Broker.
Whoa, the broker. Nothing happening here. Jalen, right hand dribble, spins in traffic, throws out to Marcus Smart. He's got time. The three is in the air and good.
Ooh, the big boys coming down the stretch like thoroughbreds. Come on, Secretariat. Come on home.
And that'd do it. That'd do it for the Hawks. That's how it sounded on 98.5, the Hub. Celtics send the Hawks packing 128-120. That ends their first round matchup. Jaylen Brown with 32. Jason Tatum with 30. It is Celtics Sixers in the second round. Meantime, Carolina Panthers selected Alabama quarterback Bryce Young first overall in the 2023 draft, while the Texans took Ohio State quarterback C.J. Stroud at 2. The Colts made it 3 quarterbacks in the top 4 when they selected Anthony Richardson out of Florida. However, Kentucky quarterback Will Levis, who was expected to be a first-round pick in the draft, was not among the 31 selections made on Thursday night. You can listen to second and third round coverage of the draft beginning at 6 p.m. Eastern on most ESPN radio stations. SportsCenter is brought to you by eBay Motors. The championship team is about each player being a perfect fit. Same with your vehicle. So for parts that fit, head to eBay Motors and look for the green check. Stay in the game with eBay Guaranteed Fit. ebaymotors.com. Let's ride. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Officially, the Ravens have announced a new 5-year agreement with Lamar Jackson.
The Ravens got an assist from the Falcons and the Commanders and all these other teams that are desperate for quarterback play. Those teams actually helped Baltimore keep Lamar Jackson by not creating any market for him whatsoever.
But for the next 5 years, that's a lot of fraud going on. Let's go, baby. Let's go, man.
Hey. You get the bag and fumble it, I get the bag.
Keyshawn and J. Willis Max, ESPN Radio. The Ravens and Lamar Jackson agreed to a 5-year deal worth $185 million guaranteed dollars. Key, you thought from the beginning this would get worked out. I thought he wasn't going to play week one because I thought he'd wait for Burrow and Herbert.
Hey.
But you know what this deal tells me?
Hey.
This 5 years, 185, tells me that there's a very good chance, and it's very difficult to prove, that the owners will.
You're going 5 year, 185, fully guaranteed, right?
That's right.
Max say, forget the 255.
Exactly.
I mean, he got the third highest guarantee out.
It's true, but look at what the owners are doing here. Deshaun signs for 230. Bishotti comes out and says no, right? That's this bad. And since then, look at all the deals. The deals are sending a clear message: we're keeping y'all under 200 guaranteed. Forget about the 200 barrier.
Come up with this head, Max.
How is that?
I'll tell you why. I saw
that's
these
not colluding. That's just business.
Well, except that there's a certain number that every owner seems to have in mind that they're not going to break. Look. Jalen Hurts under 180. The message that sends, you got to see the messages sent in negotiations and deals, right?
Yeah, let me hear Max out.
The message that sends is really we know there are, and the reason it seems like they're working as a syndicate to me is it sends is that we know there are some other guys coming up. And of course, you're going to get gradual increases of about $5 million, let's say each. 3 more deals. You start at 180 or just below. What you're saying is we'd like to end the last guy below 200. 200's the threshold. We're not crossing that right now. So Hurts, and now Lamar gets 185. Now, guess who's coming up? Three guys, actually.
Justin Herbert.
Herbert and Burrow. Let's say they're $5 million increments with each. 185, 190, 195. And then Patrick Mahomes reworks his deal at 199. Or maybe he gets to be the first guy who hits 200. But it seems to be coordinated to me. Seems to me. I can't prove it. I don't know. Maybe it's not. Seems to me.
So you know, it's a conspiracy theory.
You know, you like
it's a kind of weak conspiracy theory. Yeah.
You like a coach who came up with a bad play that's been working on that same play for about 2 weeks and tried to
a little bit.
It's
a little bit.
No, that's not no. It's okay, just that's what the market is right now. Patrick Mahomes is gonna blow the market away. Patrick Mahomes is not coming at 199.
No, he's going over 200.
And he's going to be so far over 200, it'll be ridiculous.
If that happens, then I will stand down. I'll say, you know what? I was mistaken. If he's at 199 or 200, what are you going to say?
No, he's not going to be at 199 or 200.
Or 201.
He's not going to be at 201. He's going to be at 250.
Fully guaranteed?
100%.
Okay.
He may even be honest with you so far. Yep. He may even be more than that, to be honest with you.
Ooh.
I mean, you're talking about once-in-a-lifetime generational quarterback that nobody has. Mm-hmm. This is like, you're talking about Michael Jordan. You're talking about Steph Curry, LeBron James, as if you want to equate it to basketball.
Yeah.
It's not even a conversation to be had, Max. Now, when you talk about this 5-year, 185 guaranteed money in Lamar Jackson, he deserves every single penny of it.
Mm-hmm.
They realize, recognize that they can't win without him. And I heard on the rejoin coming in that the young man or somebody said that other teams helped them keep Lamar because there was no bidding war for him. No, that's not true. Nobody was ever going to go after Lamar because all the Ravens were going to do is match it. That's the same thing I've been saying the entire time, Max. If somebody said, hey, we'll give up the two ones and we'll give him $185 million fully guaranteed, you know what the Ravens would have said? No, you're not. Because we'll give him the 185.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but Key, that works. Like, yeah, what you're suggesting, I want to play the Lamar Jackson sound because I read that very differently than you, what you just said. Same facts, but I have a different read. I'm sorry, JD. Did you
want to? No, go ahead.
Here's Lamar Jackson on his new deal.
You know, for the last few months, there's been a lot of he say, she say, a lot of nail biting, a lot of head scratching going on. But for the next 5 years, it's a lot of flop going on. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go, man. Can't wait to get there. Can't wait to be there. Can't wait to light up M&T for the next 5 years, man. Let's get it.
And then they draft Zay Flowers and they sign Odell and they already have Bateman, who hasn't really been healthy yet. Suddenly,
supposedly
has a bunch
they're
of
trying
receivers
to go for D-Hop in the draft before the
you know, it's a lot of, you know, the next 5 years, it's a lot of flock going on now. Yeah. You know what that is, right? It's the cash money.
So
y'all that hearsay, he say, she say, blah, 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 nail biting, running. In other words, let me break it down for you. All the people out there running their mouth that don't know about my business and telling me I need an agent and I'm doing this and I'm doing that.
Agent would have made
me and the team. Me and the team, we don't have a relationship. This is what he's saying. I can break it down for you. And then at the end of the end, Jay, he says, for the next 5 years, it's going to be a lot of money spent on me.
So I want to get back to your previous point.
Go ahead there, Max.
And I've noticed not just you, but several people, many people in the media have framed it as no one's going to negotiate for the Ravens. Even that framing of that, I know how it works in sports. Like, people start a whisper campaign when they want something done and they talk to different people. And everyone seems to be on the same message. No one wants to negotiate for the Ravens. That is intentionally misleading. If you don't make Lamar an offer, it's because you don't want to negotiate for Lamar. You're helping the Ravens by keeping the price down by not negotiating a contract with Lamar. Think about what you're saying, Key.
Wait.
So this goes back to your conspiracy.
Think about what you're saying. When you say the Ravens are just going to match it,
why are we still on this?
Any number they put in will be bid, makes the Ravens offer higher because they got to match it. If there's no number put in, the Ravens never have to match. That brings the market down. Now, the reason you would do that is because you want the next guy to get paid a little less, etc. That means there's some kind of coordination in my mind.
So why was Kyler Murray at 189?
It wasn't guaranteed. The guarantee was lower than 189. It was 160, something like that.
No, it's fully guaranteed, 189.5.
Not upon signing, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, what you mean?
So 189.
It's 189, man. He's the second highest guarantee.
Yes, it was.
It's 189.5, man. 5.
Lamar Jackson is the third highest guarantee.
What was it guaranteed for, though? Because I looked into this not long ago, and it turned out
the conspiracy theory.
No. I looked into this not long ago. It turned out the guarantee was not 189.
Coach, most guaranteed money.
Signing, but the guaranteed money overall.
Most guaranteed money.
I have to see what it's guaranteed for. But anyway, it's still under 190.
Single contract NFL history. It's 190.
That's what I'm saying. It started off as 189, and then Jalen Hurts went 179. And then Lamar Jackson got over Jalen Hurts at 185.
That's still, they kept Kyler under 190, which still keeps everyone far away from 200. I'm pretty sure that's not the full guarantee.
Please. I'm happy for
I just debunked the conspiracy theory. I did it.
Lamar down in Miami, he looking at them yachts right
okay.
now.
Okay, Murray's contract is for 5 years, 230.5 with 160 fully guaranteed. Or with 1 million, 160 guaranteed. Not 189.5. That's incorrect. It's 160. And I looked into this recently, so that's incorrect, and I was correct, as I said.
Now you're calling
so
out.
So it all lines up, I'm telling
now
you.
You're calling out
I cannot. Let's move on.
Now that Lamar is signed, where does this put the Ravens in the AFC? Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, ESPN Radio.
Now the team officially has announced a new 5-year agreement with Lamar Jackson.
Can't wait to light up M&T for the next 5 years, man. Let's get it.
This is Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max. The 2023 NFL Draft.
Rocket arm, quick release, seize the field.
Live from Kansas City's historic Union Station. 7 rounds, 259 picks.
Welcome, everybody.
32 teams.
So you ready for the draft? Let's get started.
The NFL Draft. Coverage of rounds 2 and 3 begin today at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN.
The Carolina Panthers are on the clock.
You can also listen on the ESPN app and on Sirius XM Channel 80.
Friday on Fitz and Harry, we're reacting to the first round of the NFL Draft, winners and losers.
Plus the one non-draft related story you need to know about.
Oh, Fitz and Harry, Friday, noon Eastern on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app.
Coming up Friday on Canty and Carlin on ESPN Radio, Lamar got his deal, so who's next to cash in? Plus all the reaction to the first round of the NFL Draft and the best players available in day two. Coming your way on Canty and Carlin on ESPN Radio, the ESPN app, Sirius XM Channel 80.
When the Stanley Cup playoffs begin on ESPN, anything is possible. So the decorations could get a little out of hand. And a city could get a new landlord. Could the freak flag fly? Could the storm surge? Could it happen for the first time? Could it happen again? Yeah, that could happen. That is playoff hockey. The Stanley Cup playoffs continue on ESPN.
This is Greeny.
Kawhi Leonard is such an extraordinary player when he plays, but he never plays. Jalen Rose sits next to me for NBA Countdown, and one of the things he tells me is Kawhi Leonard, away from the court, he walks like a 70-year-old man. Never, ever, under any circumstances, say the following words. Well, if Kawhi is going to play all the games, I just don't think you should ever count on it.
Greeny with Mike Greenberg. Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Plus, you can watch and listen on the ESPN app.
The complete 30 for 30 library is exclusively on ESPN Plus.
Maya Moore stepping away from basketball to fight for justice.
My last name is Lee, Bruce Lee.
Stream over 100 documentaries featuring the biggest names in sports, with titles including The Tuck Rule, Be Water, Lance, You Don't Know Bo, and more. The award-winning 30 for 30 library, streaming exclusively on ESPN Plus. Sign up now at ESPNplus.com or get the Disney bundle, including Disney Plus, Hulu, and ESPN Plus to stream the best movies, shows, and sports.
Bring it in. It's time for the XFL playoffs. First, the Arlington Renegades face the Houston Roughnecks for the South Division title. Then, the Seattle Sea Dragons take on the DC Defenders for the North Division crown. Renegades, Roughnecks, Saturday at 7 p.m. Eastern on ESPN2. Sea Dragons, Defenders, Sunday at 3 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. And don't miss the championship game Saturday, May 13th on ABC.
Officially, the Ravens have announced a new 5-year agreement with Lamar Jackson.
The Ravens got an assist from the Falcons and the Commanders and all these other teams that are desperate for quarterback play. Those teams actually helped Baltimore keep Lamar Jackson by not creating any market for him whatsoever.
But for the next 5 years, it's a lot of fraud going on. Let's go, baby. Let's go, man.
You ain't really wild, you a tourist. I be blacking out with the purest.
Hey, did you hear the sound coming in?
A lot of flock going on.
Keyshawn J. with the Max ESPN Radio. By not having other offers, of course, Lamar's market was kept down, not up. By not negotiating, they were helping the Ravens and not helping Lamar. Of course.
I don't believe that, but okay.
Okay. But at any rate, we looked into the guarantee for Kyler Murray. It was 160, as I said. Guaranteed. But now the high mark up for the non-Deshaun Watson guarantees is 185 by Lamar. Lamar Jackson and the Ravens were in the zone yesterday. Get in the Zone is brought to you by AutoZone. Get in the Zone, AutoZone. So, Key, you predicted that Lamar, they would work it out. Eventually they have. Now they've drafted Zay Flowers, right? They got Bateman already, who never really had a chance to show what he could fully do. Maybe he's a one, right? He's like, is he a high-pitched one or a two? Or could he really be a one? We don't know yet, but he's a talented receiver, does a lot of things well.
Yeah.
And Odell, is this the best receiving core that Lamar's ever had?
Yeah, for sure. Who else? I mean, the Hollywood Brown in that system didn't work. The interesting thing, and I was thinking about this when they took Zay Flowers, I was like, well, they could have just kept Hollywood Brown. But the problem is they were messing with Greg Roman's offense with Hollywood Brown on the team, and it didn't work. So they had to go out and get another speed demon that could be the jack of all trades and a master of none. And that's what they got. They're going to get in Zay Flowers. Then you got, obviously, Odell Beckham, who is coming back off injury, who's a veteran guy. You pair him with Bateman and put him in there with Duvernay and those guys if they can stay healthy. Now you got a nice group, right? And then in the later rounds, you go and you find you a guy that can go play. You go get you a guy in the fourth round or the fifth round that can actually play, that may be a little bit bigger, so he can do some of the dirty work, play the big X receiver on the backside of things. And Lamar continues to evolve at the quarterback position. This is why the Ravens made the move in the offseason and bringing in an offensive coordinator that knows the passing game. And so Lamar can do what people think that he can't do, and they can finally see it with their blind eyes.
Well, so Keith, tell me how you think Todd Monken's going to come in and change up this offense and make it more of a pass heavy offense, or how is he going to use the RPO game? Like, what is the balance going to be for a guy like Lamar for where he wants to go in his career?
Well, I know you look at college football, right, Jay? In college football, Max is a little bit different than the pros, clearly, right? You got grown men versus young men. Just look at Todd Monken at the University of Georgia. And look what he was able to do at Georgia. Look at how they won national championship. They pushed the ball down the field. The play action pass game was a part of their repertoire, getting the ball out quick. So when you have a quarterback coach that understands the passing game and you have an offensive coordinator that understands the passing game, you can now pair him with a skill set like Lamar Jackson, and you can do all sorts of stuff. Greg Roman, and this isn't anything negative about Greg Roman, he just isn't as sophisticated in the passing game as a guy like Todd Monken. If you go back to Greg Roman's days in San Francisco when he had Colin Kaepernick, the biggest problem there was throwing the football. They didn't evolve the passing game. And when they tried, sometimes it didn't work. Kaepernick became a full force runner, much like Lamar Jackson. So they never really gave him a true opportunity to do the things that he's capable of doing. The Ravens can only go so far running the football. They can run it, but you can only go so far. You've got to evolve. Not Lamar. The passing game has got to evolve and expand.
Well, I mean, it seems like it will now. Like, and the only question I have for Lamar, Key, this will happen like in baseball sometimes. You notice a prospect, or at least it used to, if he gets rushed through the minors and never really gets to develop because he's good enough to be in the majors right away, then he never really fully becomes what he could be because he never got to learn certain things on the way. When I look at Josh Allen, when I look at Jalen Hurts, it didn't have to happen that way for them, but they went to the right place. They had got the right internal stuff, obviously, right physical stuff. And then piece by piece, the organization surrounded them with the right stuff to aid in their development. And A.J. Brown, like, was the final finishing touch for the Eagles and Jalen Hurts' development as a quarterback, I thought. Have they waited too long with Lamar to do that? Has he missed certain like critical developmental stages that Jalen Hurts and Josh Allen have gotten?
No, but you got to go back. If you're talking about Jalen Hurts, remember Jalen Hurts was the backup. They brought in A.J. Brown. That's all they brought in. Everybody else was already in. They drafted Devontae Smith. They didn't draft Devontae Smith for Jalen Hurts. They drafted Devontae Smith for Carson
Wentz. But he still benefited from it. He still benefited from the guys there.
And Lamar Jackson is going to benefit from Bateman when he gets healthy. And Duvernay, if he can stay healthy. And OBJ, if he can stay healthy. And then they just took Zay Flowers, and they're going to probably pick another receiver. He will benefit from that. Mark Andrews, he will benefit from all that.
But that's what I'm asking, Key. I agree.
No, they didn't wait. They didn't wait too late. Not at all.
Okay,
no.
So it's not like there's some critical learning phase where if you miss that, then it's not going to be the same.
He's young, man.
Yeah, he is very young.
And Key, just think. I mean, we talked about it before. Like,
and Rich,
somebody's going to be on the outside looking in the AFC. But just think about even just the AFC North and how loaded that is now with Lamar Jackson, Joe Burrow, and the awakening of Deshaun Watson if that occurs this season.
You got to look at
News
the coaches,
said the Dolphins, too. Jay.
But I'm talking about the AFC North.
By the way, what can Kenny Pickett be?
Out of things, Nuno.
He said it in my ear, not
come
me.
Come on, Nuno. You know you want to come down to Miami and watch a Dolphin game, you'll become a Tua fan.
The top-rated quarterback in last year's draft is on Pittsburgh, right? Like, he was the first quarterback is on Pittsburgh, and, like, he was okay. He was at least like what Mac Jones was, right? Except he's more athletic. Let's see what happens. And Tomlin's
he might be better than Mac Jones.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Jones. No, I'm saying as a rookie. He was at least what Mac Jones was, but more athletic. Now let's see if he could take the next step.
That division is going to be even when they had a mix of different quarterbacks in the division, it still was competitive. Even with Baker Mayfield in Cleveland, the division was crazy. Right? It just was.
Mike Tomlin.
About the Browns for a second? Exactly. Stefanski did that on a loaded team with Baker Mayfield. Deshaun Watson, we all knew, needed a little time to shake the rust. If he's Deshaun Watson again, and there's no reason he shouldn't be on the field, that's going to be a problem. Cleveland's going to be a problem.
Well, I think all those teams are going to be a problem because they all got a certain identity and a certain style. Pittsburgh is going to always look bleh. They're not. It's never sexy. They haven't been sexy since the 70s with Stallworth and those dudes. You know, that's just not their style. They're a grinded out type team.
So I mean, the AFC North, the AFC East, you're looking at the AFC West with Sean Payton. Now, it's just
because it's one thing when you just have the quarterback. When you marry the quarterback and coach and you think highly of both, it's different. So, for example, why don't we believe in the Chargers even more? Because we like the quarterback, not sure Brandon about the coach. Staley, at least now they have an NFL level, whatever you think of them, they have an NFL level offensive coordinator there. But you look at everyone else. Cincinnati's already shown they could do it. Obviously, Kansas City, Buffalo, Miami, if Tua is healthy, the Ravens, and now they should be improved. You just mentioned the whole North.
The Jets,
Aaron Rodgers on the it's and he has Nathaniel Hackett there. It's what's that happening. The redemption of
Russell Wilson coming up
with Sean Payton for Russell Wilson. It's the biggest surprise of the draft. By the way, Lamar Jackson and the Ravens were in the zone yesterday. Get in the Zone is brought to you by AutoZone. Get in the Zone, AutoZone.
At Progressive, we love sports and saving you money, so we bundled them together.
Top of the seventh looks like a pitching change as they've set up for a corner kick. The two black belts have entered the mat, and the slider is low and away. He heads the ball to midfield. This is quite a kumite. Here comes the roundhouse. Has it got enough gas to get out of here? Unbelievable! They've bundled their home and auto insurance with Progressive. Kick savings, pitch karate!
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company, affiliates, and other insurers. Discount not available in all states or situations.
When you're an innovative business, every blinking cursor, every blank page is an opportunity. What will you do with it? Will you make something better or create something new? Our Dell Technologies advisors provide you with tools and expertise to do incredible things. Because we believe there's an innovator in all of us. For advice on smart PCs powered by Intel vPro that's built for business, call a Dell Technologies advisor at 877-ASK-DELL.
Wendy's $3 breakfast deal is a bacon or sausage egg croissant plus small seasoned potatoes for $3. It's the breakfast that don't miss. So if you did miss Wendy's breakfast, don't imagine. Fresh cracked eggs, sizzling sausage, crispy bacon, and block out those hot, buttery, flaky croissants. Croissants don't really make a sound, but if they did, for breakfast that don't miss, Wendy's is that breakfast. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's $3 breakfast deal.
Limited time only. Participating U.S. Wendy's. Select a request $3 breakfast deal to obtain discount. Not valid for a la carte or combo orders.
At USA Waste and Recycling, we're innovators, providing state-of-the-art solutions that make a positive impact on our communities today and tomorrow. We put our words into action by building the most technologically advanced recycling facility in the country, powering our buildings with efficient solar energy and fueling our trucks with all-American natural gas. USA Waste and Recycling. Some see waste, we see possibilities.
Get moving in the most electrifying Honda vehicles yet, like the CR-V and Accord, with available hybrid powertrains designed for more responsive performance. Honda, the 2022 Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com Best Value brand. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR and a 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid or 2023 Accord Hybrid.
See dealer for financing details based on 2022 brand image awards from Kelley Blue Book. Visit KBB.com for more information.
Get moving in the most electrifying Honda vehicles yet, like the CR-V and Accord, with available hybrid powertrains designed for more responsive performance. Honda, the 2022 Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com Best Value brand. For a limited time, well-qualified buyers can get a 3.9% APR and a 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid or 2023 Accord Hybrid.
Contact your local Honda dealer for a great deal today.
See dealer for financing details based on 2022 brand image awards from Kelley Blue Book. Visit KBB.com for more information.
Take the sting out of spring at Convenient MD Urgent Care. From wheezes to sneezes to rashes and tick bites, just walk in for fast and friendly care. Open every day from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Find a clinic near you at ConvenientMD.com.
A good time starts with a great wardrobe. Next stop, JCPenney. Family get-togethers to fancy occasions, wedding season too. We do it all in style. Dresses, suiting, and plenty of color to play with. Get fixed up with brands like Liz Claiborne, Worthington, Stafford, and J. Farrar. Oh, and thereabouts for kids. Super cute and extra affordable. Check out the latest in store, and we're never short on options at jcp.com. All dressed up, everywhere to go. JCPenney.
See those golden arches in every cup of McDonald's iced coffee? That's a golden promise to delight. So if you think we're just going to rest on our 100% Arabica beans, wake up to a bold new blend of McCafe iced coffee and chill flavors like French vanilla and caramel. Any size for the very bold new price of $1.79. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Keyshawn, Jay Will, and Max.
What's shocking, guys, is once the fourth pick was turned in, we saw three quarterbacks go to the top four. I don't think any of us would have sat here and said, we're done for the night with quarterbacks.
I don't know how you hold turnovers on Kentucky with the offensive line as bad as it was against Will Levis. The last 3 weeks, we've been hearing Will Levis to the Indianapolis Colts. I give Chris Ballard, the GM, a lot of credit. He kept this one sealed.
Hendon Hooker and Will Levis, more to come. Two productive SEC quarterbacks that are still available.
This is Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max on ESPN Radio. We're coming to you live from the Seaport District at Pier 17, brought to you by Chase. Good morning.
What's happening, partner?
It's Friday. Oh, isn't it?
Oh, I need this.
Oh, I need today.
I'm an idiot.
It's going to be 5 o'clock somewhere when I get off work, Key.
I'm an idiot. Why did I stay up? But like,
you know, the problem is
I could have slept and woken up in the morning and found out where the Giants picked, but I had to stay up to watch it. Say, what is it about the draft that makes you have to watch
woken?
It live?
You say woken?
Yeah.
Could have woken?
Could have awoken, son.
I could have awoken, son.
All right.
Who said it wasn't right? But the great thing about today versus yesterday.
Yeah, they sleep, son.
The great thing about today versus yesterday is I'll be able to watch the second and the third round. Mm-hmm. And then I'll be able to watch the Lakers.
Lakers tonight. Yeah. Yes. Late night on your Lake Show.
So,
and not feel bad about tomorrow.
And not feel bad on Saturday. You know,
sleeping
I
in.
Can stay up all night and watch the game without tripping. The thing is I have to manage my, how do you say it, consumption?
Your intake. Alcohol? Your intake. Consumption.
I just want to make sure that
how
Max.
How much you imbibe. Yeah.
I just want to make sure Max is okay with what I said.
Yeah. But, word police.
No, yeah, right. Word police. But you got to watch it because you get through the draft. You got to pace yourself because that thing, you know, that's about a 5 hour thing going on right there. Right.
Second and third rounds are interesting, too, Key.
Yeah. So you got to, you know, because that's how the teams are built. The teams are built on the mid rounds. And so you want to see your teams, a team, so to speak, picking in the second, picking in the third, trading out of the second and the third into the fourth for the next day. So you're looking at all those sort of things. What players that are first round grades are going in the second and third round? It's just interesting to watch. Then you got the Lakers, and then that's a whole other deal. Because we're not going to go to the game, Jay. You ain't going?
Why not?
No, because I couldn't get the tickets that I wanted, and I need multiple seats because my son's friends. We're going to have a watch party at my buddy's house instead.
Oh, that's chill.
Yeah.
Ask him, yo, Bron better come to play. Yeah, oh, it's going to be chill because his house is right.
Oh, it's super right.
It's better than going to the game.
Put it this way. Super right. It's super right.
So you talk about the second and third rounds in the draft. Whenever you're watching second, third, fourth rounds, you're thinking, damn, why didn't we just trade all those first round picks and get like we should have, you want as many because there are a lot of good players, second, third, even in the fourth round, like a lot of good players.
Yeah, no, we on our show later on at 8:30, we should have Rashee Rice on an NFL draft prospect wide receiver out of SMU. That's a guy in the second day guy who had first round grade. When you look at it though, Brett Favre went in the second round, right? I mean, you talk about certain guys that go in certain rounds. You think about Curtis Martin, who I played with the New York Jets, third round Hall of Fame running back. I mean, you just, you look at these sort of things and you say to yourself, well, how come he didn't go in the first round? Well, the guy that went before him, they at home now. My nephew is second round. All them dudes, Jay, that went before my nephew, they not even close. If he stay healthy.
Well, Key, I got another one for you. I mean, it's not second round, but I mean, last pick in the first round. Just go back to 2018. The guy that just secured the third largest guaranteed deal in the NFL yesterday in Lamar Jackson, right? Like, think about the quarterbacks that went before him. And where are they?
Mr. Irrelevant. Right? Literally the last pick in the draft was in the NFC Championship game before he got hurt, right?
It's all about value, man, what you see.
So, but there are certain positions that if you need this, you got to be usually picking in the first round. A corner is hard to find, a really good one, an elite one after the first round, right? A defensive end, you might be able to find some pieces that can approximate what a defensive end does. You know, like a good pass rusher on the outside, but he has certain holes, so he goes in the third round. But those kind of players,
see, I can find a corner. I don't have to take a corner in the first round.
Really?
Yeah. Where do you think Richard Sherman went?
That's true, but it's hard to do.
Well, no, I'm just gonna give you a couple.
Yeah.
Richard Sherman. Okay. That's one. Yeah. Right?
Well, a long time ago, though.
Well, it doesn't matter. He still went. Josh Norman, when Josh Norman was on top. Mm-hmm. I mean, so you don't have to. Those type of, that's why I always tell, unless you have a guy that has Hall of Fame potential at the receiver or the defensive back position, whether it's a safety or a corner, you can get that because the one thing that you want is somebody who can run. To take a guy in the first round high, you got to have some rare, you got to have some stuff. Mm-hmm. Got to be big, fast, can jump out the gym, just be ridiculous. For me to say, I got to have that guy up there. Because otherwise, I can wait to get that guy to build out my roster and be just fine with it.
Especially when you talk about team building. That's what triggered that thought when you said team building. If you had 2 3-seconds, 2 3-thirds, couple fourths, you could put together, you have two holes on the offensive line you can fill. You got a thing over safety.
Think about it. You take Darrell Revis. You take that. Because Darrell Revis was going to be a Hall of Famer. You grab that.
Matter of fact, you move up to grab that.
Yeah, you grab those guys. But then there's other players in those middle rounds that can pick them up and put them down too that may need a little push, may need a little growth, may need a little time.
Right, not as many guarantees. The floor isn't as high. What was the biggest surprise of the draft to you? Key, what was the biggest surprise of the draft to you?
The biggest surprise was Houston getting back to three. I didn't even think about that. That wasn't even something on my mind that they would trade and come up to three and get Will Anderson. Once they selected CJ Stroud, I moved on. I was like, oh, okay. Well, now in my mind, I started thinking, okay, Houston's taking CJ Stroud. Arizona's sitting at three. They got their opportunity now to grab Will Anderson. They could maybe get Jalen Carter if they choose to do so. And then when Houston traded up, I'm like, well, what did they go? Oh, I know what they're doing. They getting Will Anderson because they just took C.J. Stroud and said, well, we wanted both of them because if in fact, for some reason, this is the way I'm thinking, is that if the Panthers decided to take C.J. Stroud or Will Levis or somebody else at the quarterback spot, Houston would have said, you know what, we either trading out or we're going to take Will Anderson. But once they didn't, C.J. Stroud was a higher guy on the board and an absolute need. They said, we're going to get C.J. Stroud, but we got this other thing. Arizona doesn't want him. Let's give Arizona this. Let's go up and get Will Anderson because if he drops, Will Anderson is going to either drop to Seattle and Seattle may pluck him or they may take Jalen Carter. And they made the move. So when I saw that, I was like, damn, okay. That's what they're supposed to do. They're building.
For me, I mean, it was our division rival, man. I mean, well, a couple. But it's the Eagles. It's just, you know, I was telling Nuno, our producer, I was watching Michael Parsons do this thing on Sports Illustrated the other day. And I had, like, multiple screens up watching the draft. And when the Eagles got Jalen Carter, he walked off the damn set. Right? Like, man, Jalen Carter dropped down to go to the Eagles. And then on top of that, now you get a chance to pair him with Jordan Davis.
Nolan Smith at the end of the first round. Crying out loud.
Kobe Dean. I mean, it's just like they got loaded.
Yeah, they got Davis, as they say, Kobe Dean, And now you know they got four guys off the front seven of the best front seven ever in college.
The rich got richer.
Richer, man, yeah. Did they?
I want to go back to the Texans.
I need to look and see what other picks they have. The Eagles.
Yeah, exactly. Let's go back to the Texans for a second with Will Anderson and C.J. Stroud. What occurs to me is they took the guys with the fewest warts, right? Like all prospects, not all, but most prospects have some warts, right? Like, well, if this is the thing on this guy, but C.J. Stroud checks all the boxes. The only thing is his S2 test wasn't, but the tape he had in college, the size, accuracy, mobility, they're not as many. Well, Bryce Young is little and Richardson is raw and right. Like there, and Hooker's coming off an ACL and Stroud checks them. And same thing with Will Anderson. He's, you know, when you go to the character plus the athletic ability, plus the tape he has from college, the numbers he put up, like they took the two kind of safest picks at that level of the draft, it seems to me.
And not only that, so you have to follow two organizations and programs on a building. They're trying to get somewhere fast. And how you get there fast is you go and you get guys from big programs, right? They took Stingley last year from LSU, a corner, right? Now they go and they get a guy from Alabama and Ohio State. You get big programs that understand how guys that understand how to play at the professional level because they're being taught like professionals at Alabama and at Ohio State. Those are many NFL programs. We're not talking about somebody, and this is not a shot at any other smaller schools, but we're not talking about somebody getting drafted high from New Mexico State.
Yeah.